Hello, everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. Please invite your friends, and don't forget to share the video as soon we download it and share it with everybody. As many people, they download the videos and they share it. Today, our topic is about how to approach a Muslim. And supposedly, I will speak about how, or this is what I understand from the question, how we make a Muslim accept Jesus or convert to Christianity. First of all, I'm not here trying to make Muslims convert to Christianity. I'm not. I'm here to share the truth. And then he convert to Christianity. That's not me. If he find that Christianity is where the truth is, then this is his choice. So my duty or your duty as a Christian is to share the truth, to tell the truth. Now who accept or reject, this is his business. So let us not to make the target is converting them as much the target is to be truthful with them. After being truthful with somebody, then it is his business to accept the truth or to reject the truth. And the reason I say I don't want really to convert them, I want to share the truth with them, because converting somebody, it's not in your hand anyway. And it's not your decision anyway. And if you convert him by lying to him, that's mean you are a liar, the same as he, you know, I mean, he was believing in a lie before, and now he is believing in an additional lie. So the target for a Christian is to be a Christian, and to be a Christian is to be truthful. And to be truthful, you have to share the truth and the truth only. And then whoever want to believe, he believe. Whoever don't want to believe, clean the dust of your sandal from his house, as the Bible says. So how to approach a Muslim? You see, every human being is different. If I'm walking in this beach here and there's a Muslim with me, he might say to me, oh, Christian, look, this is what Allah created. And that will give me an opportunity to speak about Allah. So the best way to approach a Muslim is not to you speak about God. Wait for him to say it. And usually Muslims, when they see a Christian, they try to harass him. So it's going to come. Just wait, have patience. And the reason I say that, because when he opened the door is different from you opening the door. The Muslim always, he play victim. Oh, because I'm a Muslim, he's harassing me. The Muslims are, you know, they are oppressing everybody in the world. And the second you go launch, let us say, some kind of exposed to his cult, it's the same second he play a victim. So let him start. Let him say something. I never saw a Muslim, he sit with me and he find out that I am a Christian and he don't right away go and attack me. Right away. The second they knew you are a Christian, they will say something. And for sure, this is generally speaking. So wait for him to say something. And the second he say it, you go from there. Every human being is different. Everyone, he think differently. So today we are going to find out how really we can talk to them. Can somebody give me something like, first time a Muslim, he asked about Christianity, what he asked you about? Anyone remember? Anyone remember? Like, what is the first question a Muslim he gave you? Give me one. Just to show you like how you can take the question and make it used for your benefit. It's Trinity. You see, when a Muslim he says to you, okay, how you believe in the Trinity? The question is, how you believe in Allah? He says to you, Allah, he said. Okay, I said, my God, he said. Are you a person of double standard? My God, he said, I believe. Your God said, you believe. So it's not about how. It's about you accept whatever it says there. It's not because it's how and it's convincing. As an example, if a Muslim, he speaks to you about Jesus, he will never make fun of Jesus being born of a virgin. But have you ever heard of a virgin giving birth? No. So why you accept Jesus is born of a virgin? Because it says so in the Quran. So the Muslim is not discussing really if this is possible or not. He is just discussing blindly without using his brain. That how that can be. Well, this is why we call him Almighty God. Almighty God is the one who can do what nobody can do. So if it's impossible to God to be three person but yet one, it's mean impossible for him to be God anyway. Are you getting my point? Why we call him Almighty then, if he is not Almighty? Either you believe he's Almighty or not. Mr. Justice, he's asking me, here we go. Mr. Justice is helping us. He says, are you pagan? Well, Mr. Justice, the pagan is the one who kisses stones and pray in front of stones, and he bow down to stones, and that is Islam, my friend. We Christians, we have nothing like this. It is you Muslims who believe that the stones can forgive your sin. If you touch the stones, they erase your sin. And you know what? I don't like to say things without proof. Here we go. This is your prophet teaching the Muslims that touching stones around the Kaaba erase your sin. So who is the pagan? So this is a great question, actually. When a Muslim, he says to you, are you a pagan? Well, right away you show him that the pagan is the one who believe in the following, that God, he have a right hand, and the right hand of Allah is a black stone. And this is your prophet saying, not me, that touching two corners of the Kaaba erase your sin, the black stone and the Yemeni corner. Are you there, Mr. Justice? Now, Mr. Justice, he will go and take a hike and he will hide because he cannot explain to us how touching stones will forgive your sin. So what we notice here, that if you are not armed with knowledge, a Muslim, he can ask you questions and he try to make it embarrassing for you. But the fact, if you have knowledge, that the same question is going to be embarrassing for him. Now show me where Jesus says go and kiss stones or worship stones. Show me where Jesus says that, you know, we have a holy stone. Show me where Jesus says that a stone is the right hand of God. Show me where Jesus says that a stone is going to witness for me in the day of judgment, is going to have two eyes and will have a tongue. So the Muslim is a pagan with certification, yet he accuses everybody to be pagan. Do you believe it? Let me see where I can find the hadith about the black stone with tongues. Just to show you how pagan this cult is. Yet they accuse everybody to be pagan. It's part of your religion and the system of your God, stones. Here we go. The messenger of Allah said about the black stone, by Allah, Allah will raise it in the day of resurrection with two eyes, which it sees, and a tongue that it speak with, testifying to whoever touch in truth. Are you there, Mr. Justice, or you took a hike? So, Mr. Justice, he said to you, as a Muslim, he is a Muslim, and you are a Christian, are you pagan? Now, we discovered that the pagans are Muslims, not us. We don't believe that the stones can erase our sin, as Muhammad said. That is paganism. Because the one who erases your sin is God, and touching stones will not make any difference, unless you are a pagan person. So Muhammad is a certified pagan, and we are using his own text. We are not using something from our pocket. And here what the Muslims will do. Oh, I don't accept this hadith. I don't care if you accept it or not. You see, the Muslim, they say, I don't accept. It is a very good sign that he is now in a revolutionary mood. He don't like what his prophet said. He is disgusted. He is ashamed of him. And now we want to dump all what his prophet said. Do you understand? So when a Muslim, he says, this hadith is da'if. Da'if, what da'if? Da'if mean weak. But even the weak hadith, by the way, is accepted. But this is the ignorant, they say that. You know, da'if, da'if. Okay, so what does that mean? It's mean Islam is a corrupt religion. Isn't it Islam based on the hadith and the Quran? So if you are saying to me that the hadith, which is Muhammad's speech, and the Quran, which is Muhammad's speech anyway, is corrupt, that means you have no belief. So how you will know which one is the one you trust? How we will know which one to trust? Why Allah did not preserve the hadith as long Quran is not enough alone? You see, the Muslims, all of them, they agree that Quran alone is not enough. And actually, those who believe in Quran only, those are apostate. They are apostate because the Quran says so. The Quran says that you have to obey Allah and you have to obey the messenger. Actually, some verses says that you have to obey the prophet first. And then you obey Allah. Whoever obey the messenger, he obey Allah. Okay, so how you obey the messenger if you don't have his words to be obeyed? Do you understand me, people? Guys, don't repeat the text. I saw you, Samson, please. You know, I'm not a blind, my friend. It's okay, but we have a topic. Don't worry, don't worry. You are talking to Christian Prince. I appreciate that you are giving me a hand. You know, I mean, it's okay. I really appreciate that. But don't repeat the text. You are just spamming now. Let us, guys, take it easy. Don't worry, don't worry. We will cover it all. I mean, I spank Muhammad every day, 24 hours, 7 days a week. Do you know how many people left Islam just in the last 24 hours when I am offline? Speaking to people in Skype, you don't know. Take it easy. This cult is destroyed already, and the one who destroyed is Muhammad, not me. Now look at this. He who obeyed the messenger. If you say to me that the hadith is not trustworthy, how we can obey the messenger? Correct, guys? If you are saying to me that the hadith is full of garbage, okay, I want to now obey the Quran. Allah ordering me to obey Muhammad. And obviously, obey Muhammad is mean obey the words of Muhammad, the orders of Muhammad. Okay, where we can find the authentic orders of Muhammad? To make it simple, what is authentic is not authentic anymore. Because depend in the mood of the Muslim, if the hadith is embarrassing, they say, we don't accept it. I will give you a very easy example. I will give you something funny. All right. Satan, he do fart when he hear the prayer of the Muslims. But this is a very authentic hadith. Okay, any Muslim here, he have a problem with this hadith. Who is the Muslim agree with this hadith and who is the Muslim who rejected? That shaitan, he do fart when you pray. And that explains the global warming. Any smart Muslim who have little education, he will say, this is a joke. This can't be true. But this is authentic. This is authentic. So because it's embarrassing, they say we don't accept it. And this is a very good sign. That's mean the Muslim now, he start thinking. He start what? Thinking, which is unusual. It hurt. See, if you did not move your hand for long and you try to move it, it hurt. Because you did not use it for a while. So when the Muslim, he see those things which is proving Muhammad to be a false man, he get hurt. And because he got hurt, he scream, he says things we should not, he should not say, or he reject to save himself from the stupidity which we see in the front of us. When Muhammad, he said, aren't you afraid? Can you stream about the reformation? What reformation? What reformation? Islam reformation? There's no such a thing. It's a big fat lie. When Muhammad, he says as an example this. If you raise your head before the Imam, Allah will transform your head to a head of a donkey. Okay, how come we don't see one person in the world who raised his head before before the Imam, his head turned to be a head of a donkey? Never happened. That's mean Muhammad is a fraud. So a Muslim who have little, you know, courage, he will say, well, this prophet, either he is lying to us, making fun of us, trying to scare us like kids in the old days when we were like, you know, there's a beast outside. If you go in the dark, he will eat you. Or he is telling the truth. Right? So you have to take one. And obviously, Muhammad is not being truthful. So if Muhammad is speaking to the Muslims, trying to scare them, that's when Muhammad considers Muslims are a bunch of kids and he don't respect them. Additional to that, you do not make people practice something based on fear, but not based on the truth. Somebody saying this is narrated hundreds of years after Muhammad. The Quran narrated hundreds of years after Muhammad. So what we will do? This is not my business. Why this hadith is accepted for the last 14 centuries and now it is not? What happened? What happened? That's the people today, they get smarter and they are more educated, and this is stupid. So the only solution, they say, oh, this is I reject this hadith, it's weak. You know what I mean? But the fact, this is was not rejected. This is why it's called Sahih. The name of the book, Sahih. Do you know what Sahih mean? Sahih mean accurate, authentic. So this is a book called Sahih. Imagine the book, it's called Sahih, is wrong. So the only way for them to escape the humiliation and the stupidity of the cult founder is to say, I don't accept this hadith. Secondly, the issue I raised, my friend, there's nothing is called reformation of a Christianity. There's nothing like that, my friend. You know, from the beginning, always man is a corrupt man. Man is a corrupt. This is why man is not in heaven. So man, he do corruption. And man can use God or religion for his benefit. And this is nothing new. So the reformation you are talking about is just a political. Otherwise, Christianity does not need to be reformed, because we have the teaching of Christ. Do you understand me, my friend? So if there is a priest, he is a scumbag, we'll get rid of him. Don't go to his church. That's it. There's nothing is called reforming Christianity, because Christ, he gave us the perfect belief. We need to fix ourselves. So this is not about a sect or about, it's about, you know, everywhere there's people who take advantage. Even if it's a Catholic or Protestant or Orthodox, there is people who they are liars, thieves, like Judah. They all exist from the time of Jesus. Judah, he was one of the disciples. So always there is Judah. All right? So what you are saying have nothing to do with the Christianity. Because nobody can reform the teaching of Christ, for it is perfect and amazing and beautiful. Love your enemy. Pray for those who curse you. How you can reform that? Actually, a human being cannot reach to be noble, not even in a billion years from now, to say love your enemy. Now, some naive people, they say Islam need to be reformed. And that is a stupid statement too, because how you can reform Islam? Are you going to reform Muhammad? His words is here, his Quran is there, and that's it. In order to reform such a thing, you have to get a new book. Samson, I have to give you time out, and I will block you if you keep repeating the topic. If you are not adult, mature, please don't stay here. I said many times, don't repeat your text. Anyone will repeat the text. I will give it to you like the same as Muhammad. Three times only. If you repeat it more than three times, I will ban you. That means you are a kid and you are not listening. So, when a Muslim come to me, he bring a topic. And that topic is going to be used against him. Give me another topic. Can somebody tell me? Why did God made us so corrupt? No, God did not make us so corrupt. God, he gave us a free will. This is why not every one of us, he do what someone else does. There's some, they are child molesters. There's some, they are thieves. You know, so everybody have his own way of guilt. But there's guilt, there's a guilt like mountains, and there is somebody, maybe his eye look at a woman walking in the street. There's a huge difference between what people do. Now, can you give me another topic, Muslims, they hit you with it? We answer you about the Trinity. The Trinity, if they say to you the Trinity, say, well, God, he says that he is a three in one, so what the problem? If he cannot be three and one in the same time, that's mean he cannot be God. For he is almighty. And he can be as he wish, not as you wish. Is the Muslim who designed how Allah is? No. Is the Muslim who chose how Allah is? No. So how they accept their God who have a shin, he have a hand, he have five fingers, he have a leg, he have two eyes, he have two right hand, two right hands, yeah. Which is funny. And nobody asked him why. Nobody asked Allah why you have two hands in the right side of you. What's happened? Is that a birth defect? Why do you don't question Allah for how he look like? Why Allah have two eyes anyway? If Allah is all seeing, how you can see with two eyes everything? Yeah, the one who is asking how to approach Muslims, my friend, if you just join now, we'll play the video from the beginning. You don't approach the Muslims will approach you. Wait for them, don't worry, they will. Muslims cannot resist seeing somebody believe in Christianity and not to come to him and try to convert him. But you have to be ready. And if you are a fool, don't open your mouth. If you are ignorant, don't claim education. And if you do not know your book, don't debate about anyone about his book. So first you have to study your book very well. Otherwise, why you are talking about religion if you don't have even one? Secondly, study very well their logic and their belief. Arm yourself with knowledge. Knowledge is the key of winning souls and sharing the truth. Ignorance will bring nothing but ignorance. How to answer Muslims when they say they eat halal meat? I mean, what does this have to do with my topic? First of all, halal meat. I mean, is that important, really? Halal meat. First, my friend, a Muslim, he can eat even a pig. Because Allah, he said to them, I allow you to eat the food of the people of the book. And as long he is allowed to eat the food of the people of the book, which means the Christians, that's mean he can eat our food with no problem. But my friend, we are exist in the words of donkeys who do not know what they are talking about. If we go in the Quran right now, we will find the following. Chapter 5, verse number 5. Do you see it? It's lawful for them to eat our food, whatever it is. Whatever it is. So this is what the stupid, you know, the problem is, there is people, they call themselves religious, but they don't even know what is religious mean, and they do not know what is their religion is. So a Muslim, he have no excuse to eat from your food or not, because it's made lawful for him to eat all kind of food presented by a Jew or a Christian without a questioning what is inside the food. You see, it doesn't say I make lawful for you some of their food. It says it make lawful for you their food, whatever they slaughter. So the problem is that we have people who they are ignorant, and ignorant, they don't teach you religion. Ignorant, they teach you their ignorance. Now, we go back to the topic. They ask how God can sleep. Okay, well, where we find that Jesus, he was sleeping, isn't it the same time when Jesus, he was in the boat and he controlled the storm? So if a Muslim asks you how God can sleep, well, how he is asleep but he is controlling the nature around him, how a man, this just to show you the hypocrisy, when a Muslim he asks you a question, always when he says to you, okay, how God can be God yet he eat, yet he sleep? Well, how Jesus is just a man who sleep and eat, yet he can control nature. He can make the blind see. He can create from the mud the bird, living bird. He can tell you what is hiding in your house, as the Quran says. They will say to you, by the will of Allah, that is your claim. What is confirmed is that Jesus can do what no man can do. So why, when you want Jesus can do what no man can do, only God can do, and when you want Jesus is just a man? You see the hypocrisy? And if we say that God he sleep, what does sleeping mean? Is that him being out of knowledge and aware? Prove it to me. Jesus is being asleep or not, still he can read your mind. Still he knew what you are doing. Still he can control the nature, and the Bible is right there. In the Quran, we see that Jesus, he can tell you what you hide in your houses, even though you are not with him, and maybe he was asleep. Does it say that? I tell you what you hide in your houses. Okay, how Jesus he knew that? He was asleep at home. And I inform you of what you eat and what you store in your houses. This is Quran, chapter 3, verse number 49. The Muslim, they will say to you, by the will of Allah, this is your claim, but it's confirmed that Jesus, he knew what you store in your houses. Now, can you prove to me that Allah, he knew what we store in our houses? You cannot. Actually, I can prove the opposite. Because if Allah, he knew what we store in our houses, then Allah should not know, should know how the baby is created. But the Quran says that the baby is created from a sperm, which became a congealed dead blood. So what kind of God he knew? Look at this God. Allah did not sleep, and Jesus doesn't sleep. But Jesus who sleep, he can inform you while he is sleeping what you have in the other room or in the other house, which is in a different city. And Allah who do not sleep, he do not know how he made the baby. Are you getting my point? Now, how many of you is taking notes? How many of you taking notes? You see, I answer Muslims from their books. I don't use my book because they will say, oh, we don't believe in it. So why you want to waste your time? Get him busted from his book. So what the Quran confirmed, that Jesus, even if he is asleep, he can see what you do in your home. Who is saying so? The Quran. You cannot hide anything from Jesus, is what the Quran is saying. I know what you did, I know what you stored, I know what you said, I know what you have in your houses. So how Jesus can do that? They will say to you, Allah, by Allah, leave. This is your claim. I can say that I am the one who gave the leave to Jesus. Hey, Jesus, you did make the blind see because I am CP. I made you do that. That is a stupid argument. Prove it to me. Muhammad, all his lifetime, could not make one person see as Jesus did. Muhammad was busy making verses. Any woman she want to give herself to the prophet so he can do boom, boom with her. Where is the miracle of Muhammad? If I type one word in the Quran, ayah, which means a miracle, right? Ayah. Okay, look what it says. They say to him, why his God don't give us a miracle? Why his God don't even speak to us? Why Allah don't give us any miracle, any sign? Why this guy is a prophet but he have nothing? And Muhammad, he says, well, you know, if you give them a miracle or not, they will not follow you. And even if you were to bring to the people of the scriptures, the Jews and the Christians, ayat, proofs and evidence. Ayat, it's mean miracles. This guy, the translator, he's adding verses, listens. That's stupid. It's a miracles. So even if you bring them, they will not follow you. And by the way, this is a proof Muhammad to be a false prophet. Because who are those in YouTube who they are Muslims supposedly claiming that they used to be Christians and they became Muslims? Do you understand? If the Quran confirmed, none of the Christians and none of the Jews will convert to Islam even if you bring them a miracle. And that to explain why Muhammad, he have none and zero. So who is this guy? You have a video of him in YouTube converted to Islam. That's me. Muhammad is a liar. This is a false prophecy. And why Muhammad don't have a sign and Jesus have all the signs? If Jesus, he have the ability to tell you the unseen by the will of Allah or the leave of Allah, where is the leave of Allah when it's come to Muhammad? Do you understand, my friend? Give me another question. We answer about Jesus, he sleep. Jesus, he sleep, he tell you what you hide in your houses. Jesus, he sleeps, still he can make you blind. Make the blind see. Jesus, you know, he sleep, still he can make the one who cannot walk, walk. Jesus, who sleep, he can still make from the mud a living bird. And this is who? Jesus, the one who sleep. So because they are bankrupt, they remember that Jesus, he sleep, but they don't remember what Jesus can do, what nobody can do. And this is my challenge to the old Muhammadan. Can you name for me one person he can do what Jesus does in your religion, including Allah? Can Allah create a mosquito? If they say yes, prove it. Actually, we can prove easy that Allah cannot be the creator of anything. Look at this. If we go in the Quran, we will find some of the most funny things ever. Allah is speaking science. Allah is the one who has created every living creature from the water. Every living creature created from the water. Who is a Muslim agree with this? Who is a Muslim agree that Allah created every living creature from the water? Anyone in the bushes? Who is a Muslim agree with this verse in the Quran? Again, a warning, anyone who speak about different, any Christian sect, I will ban you from the text. Anyone he say the word Protestant, Catholic, Orthodox in the text, please admins, just block him immediately. Any Muslim, he have an answer. Do you believe that everything is created from water according to Islam? Look at them. We have a lot of Muslims listening, but nobody have the courage to say I agree. Any Muslim would like to call me and say that he agree with this, just to show you that Allah cannot be the creator, because the creator, he knew what he created. Very simple, you know. So the question is, do this creator, he knew what he created, or he is ignorant about his creation? I never heard of a creator. He is the last one to know what happened and done by his hands. Let us see. All right. Anyone? I'm waiting for a Muslim. No, Christianity does not have destiny. That's false. The destiny we are talking about in Christianity, that God he chose, let us say, God he chose people. As an example, God he chose Mary. All right, but this is not a destiny, because Mary still can accept or reject to be a believer. So God he can choose me to do a mission, but yet I can be, even though I'm chosen, to reject that mission. And I will give you an example. Is it true, guys, that Jesus accepted Judah as disciple of him? He did, right? Okay. Here we go. God, he made a choice that this person, he will be a disciple of mine. Then Judah, he decide he don't want to be. He betrayed God. So this is a very false argument. It work only with naive people who have a low IQ. It doesn't work with us. We don't believe in such a thing. God, he created angel, or he created Satan. He created actually angel. But then angel, he decided to be Satan. So even angels in Christianity, they have a freedom of a choice. Right? Somebody's asking why he would choose you if he knew you would reject his mission. So you would reject. And you would do what you need to do. You know, why God, he will punish you if you did not commit a crime? You see, people are like kids. It doesn't matter what you say. And why God he chose me if he knew I'm rejecting? Well, God he said to you, you are free. And now you are asking him, why you make me free? The question is not why he chose you. He chose all of us actually to believe in him. Every single one of us, he chose us to believe in him, but we reject. So very naive and very, I mean, don't get married. The one who posed that question, I advise you, don't get married for the coming 10 years, because you are obviously not mature. right? God, he chose us to live in his kingdom, and he loves us. What we choose to reject him. Muslim says Bible is corrupt. Okay, we look like nobody want to speak about Allah created everything from water. Okay, let us talk about the Bible as being corrupt. Who is the Muslim who says that? Is he in the chat or? Is he in the chat, the one who says the Bible is corrupt? Is he here? One by one. Is the one who says the Bible is corrupt, is he in the chat? Okay, this is a Muslim. His name is CP Destroyer. All of them, they destroy me. Have you ever seen a Muslim don't destroy me? Okay, let us see who destroy who. As long you say that the Bible is corrupt, thank you very much. You just proved to us Islam to be false. Because according to your cult, the one who sent the Bible is Allah. So what you are saying to me, you are not accusing me, you are accusing your God. You are saying that my God Allah is a shish kebab, anyone can spank him and he can change his book, and what he can do about it, nothing. Isn't it your God? He says he is the one who said the Injil and the Torah. Huh? Is that your book or my book? Busted. So a Muslim, when he says to you, your book is corrupted, he is saying his book is corrupted. Because according to them, this is the book which Allah he sent. So who is the stupid here? The one who say his book is corrupted, or the one who says my book is not? So you are the one who's saying your book is corrupted, not me. We don't agree. You as a Muhammadan, you are saying that I have a God, his name is Allah, he sent the Torah, he sent the Injil, and yet you Christians, you spank him in his ass and you corrupted his book. Well, thank you very much. That is a proof that Allah cannot be God. Are you there, Mr. Destroyer? Are you brushing your teeth with the miswak now? Who is a Muslim when I answer this? Secondly, we are not done with this topic because this topic is fun. Did Allah allow the Torah and the gospel to be corrupted by his will or against his will? Who is the Muslim want to give me the answer? Who is the Muslim want to give me the answer? Anyone? Was this corruption happening by Allah's will or against his will? Any Muhammadan? As you see, the Quran is confirming what is with us. You see here, even the Muslim translation, because they are liars, excuse my voice, it's not good. It says here, نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. Approving what is between his hands, which is what? The Torah and the Gospel. How Muhammad, he approve it if it's corrupt? Now we are waiting for the answer. The Torah and the Gospel, you Muslims, you claim it's corrupted. Was it corrupted against Allah's will or by Allah's will? The Bible prophet, Allah does not say Bible. It says Injil. This is additional proof that Allah is a scam. Why? Because Injil is a Greek word. So if Allah and Muslims say that Jesus was sent to the Jews, why his book is in a Greek? Isn't it your silly Quran says we never send a messenger unless he speak the language of his people so they might understand? So the Bible should be in Hebrew according to the Quran only. Because you Muslims claim that the only one is a messenger for all mankind is Muhammad. Okay, so how the book, it's called Injil, which is a Greek, yet Jesus, he should be speaking only Hebrew and his followers, they speak Hebrew. Are you there, Abdul? Additional proof that Muhammad is under the influence of the Greek Christians. They don't have Arabic Bible. He heard about Injil, so he used the word Injil. Additional proof that Muhammad is a scam. Now we go back to zero. Who is the Muslim want to tell me, is the Bible of Allah corrupted by his will or against his will? Who want to answer? Any Muslim can answer this question? They cannot. They cannot. Because if they say, you see, as long they are coward to answer, if they say according to his will, that's mean Allah is the devil. He sent us a book and he decided to corrupt it. So what's my problem? If they say, if this is his will, if they say this is against his will, that's mean Allah, his will doesn't match and doesn't make any difference. Who is the one who corrupted the book? And what is the involvement of Allah? Isn't it Allah, he says, لا مبدل لكلمات الله. Nobody can change the words of Allah. Nobody can change the words of Allah. So Allah make a challenge. Nobody can change his words. And yet you says to me that the word of Allah changed. So Islam is a stupid cult. Any Muslim? And this is how easy it is to prove Islam to be stupid when they say to you the Bible is corrupt. Right? Because they are talking about their Bible, which supposedly the Bible of Allah is corrupt. So what's my business? This is accusation against his God, not against me. You see, I have books. I have many books. Now, if I write a book and somebody else corrupted my book, isn't it my responsibility, the author, to protect my book? Or the responsibility for someone who's in the street? This is my book. So if Allah is the one who sent the Injil and he is the one who sent the Torah, that means it is the responsibility of Allah, and the Quran confirmed that. That nobody can change the word of Allah. And then you come to me and you say, okay, well, the Injil is corrupted. You just prove to me that Allah is a liar, because he says nobody can change his words, yet you are saying the word is changed. Are we taking notes, guys? Are we taking notes? The word here referred to decree, promise. Decree, promise. Okay, let me get you busted. It is not. It's about a book. Here we go. The verse before it. Now you are a certified donkey and you are earning a one-way ticket to Mecca. Do you see it says? We reveal to you the scriptures and nobody can change the words of Allah. So you are a donkey now. Actually, I take it back. You don't deserve such a title. Who is next? Ah, you remind me of the word donkey. Your God, he think he is the one who created the mule. Look like your God, he do not know that the mule is not created by him. It was the fruit of one night stand date. Allah created the mule. How is that? Hello. And horses and mules. What? Allah created the mules? Are you sure? He created the mule who is the originator. Okay, hold on. You see, if you create the originator, then you do not need to mention the mule, because you did not create the mule. You created the horses and the asses. The mule is not your creation. When you say you created the mule, it's mean you made a creature by itself from the beginning. It's called the mule. Hold on, let me show you something. Allah is a Discovery Channel. Look what Allah he says. Those things nobody knows except Allah. You know? Allah has created every animal of water. By the way, does it say every animal? No, it says every dabba. Anything live in the earth or a living creature is created of water. And then he continues saying, and he and those, some of them, they walk in their belly. The word in Arabic here is walk, yamshi, not a creep. But animals, they don't walk in their belly. They creep. This is a wrong Arabic. And then some of them, he have two legs. And some of them, they have four legs. Are you sure? That's it? This is the creation of Allah? Okay, how many legs the spiders have? Any Muslim can tell us? How many legs the spider he has? Do you see only four? What about those who have many legs? How Allah claiming that he is the one who created every living creature in this earth from water, and either they walk in their belly, which is false, or they walk with two legs or four legs? Well, just go. Change your name at least. Any Muslim have an answer? Did you hear about this insect? She have a date and she wanted to go and meet her boyfriend, and she was late because she have to wear 44 high heels shoes. Look like Allah never heard of those things. He never do, as usual. What kind of God does God is? He think that either they have two or three or four. So who is this gentleman there? Who is this? Oh boy. This is God? Same time, every creature, every living creature is created from, let us get better translation, this translation is false, is created from water. Here we go. This is better. Every living thing, every moving thing, this is correct actually, a creature created from water. Who is a Muslim agree with that? Anyone? Let me give you the answer, showing you that Allah cannot be God from the Quran. The Quran says that Allah created the genie from fire. Do you see it? Where is the water? Chapter 38, verse number 76. And genie, he live in the earth, remember. And not only that, the Muslim believe that genie, he can even can have sex with them. If you search right now in Google, you will find tons of articles and books written by Muslims about genies having sex with Muslim women or Muslim man having sex with the female genie. Okay, that's okay. Just hold on. Do you see it? So the verses where it says that Allah created every living thing from water is wrong, because the same book confirmed that genie, and who is a living thing, is created from fire. Correct? Hey, my friend, I don't read the Bible to dismiss the Quran. Here we go. The Quran is dismissing itself. I do not need to use the Bible. And the reason I don't use the Bible to dismiss the Quran, because why I want to do that? Because the Muslims will say to you, I don't accept the Bible anyway. But when you show them this from their Quran, you are not wasting your time and the story is over. Can they say, I don't accept this? They cannot. All right? Do you understand me? So when you speak to a Muslim, if you want to destroy Islam, avoid speaking about the Bible unless it is necessarily, because at the end of the day, this guy, he don't believe in your book. So what? Why you? What? I mean, it's like a, it's somehow not smart. Get him busted first using his own book, and then he cannot say, I don't agree with this book. Do you understand me? And then after he is accepting the reality that the Quran is a book of contradiction and stupidity, then you can give him the jewels you have, which is the Bible. You understand? You notice that when you come to listen to me, I don't speak about the Bible reading. I speak about it only just to get somebody busted. He said something not true. But I confirm Islam to be false using only Islamic books and Quran and Hadith, something the Muslims agree upon. Now, how Allah says he created every living thing from water, then the shaitan, who is a genie, created from fire. Obviously, Muhammad, he forgot what he said. Muslim and the proud is saying Islam is the truth, you cannot debate about Christianity. Okay, well, my friend, what about you give me a call right now? Why you don't give me a call, and why you want to debate only about Christianity? You know what, I will give you a golden opportunity. One question from you, one question from me, is that fair, guys? Ask me whatever you wish and I ask you whatever I wish. If you are the man, give me a call. If you are not, just put your tail between your legs and let your mama call me. Because I have a question for her about how to make falafel. Are you the man? Are you the man if you challenge? Everybody saw your text that I cannot defend the Christianity. By the way, I don't defend Christianity. Why I want to defend Christianity? Christianity stand by itself strong. Now bring me your best. One question from you, one question from me. But now what you will do, you will take a nap and you will say, I'm busy. I'm washing dishes for my wife. Which one of them? The first or the second or the third or the fourth? Are you there? He's dead. Look, he's dead. He's not even texting no more. And the reason he posted this text, he thought, I will not read it. He said, I will challenge him, but he will not read it, and that's going to go through. And then I will take a snapshot. I will go show it to my wife, says, I challenge the Christian prince today. And the coward, he ignored my text. Let me make it clear. All of you Muslims right now, the 1 billion Muslim, you can call me right now. My Skype is open. You Muslims, you don't dare to have your Skype open for us to call. I ask Zakir Naik. I ask, well, all those kids like Mimi Hijab, Ali Dawa, and the nurse Ali Dawa, all those kids, they will never do, dare to do that. I have my Skype is open. I'm desperately waiting for a Muslim to call me. Sometimes I feel like somebody begging for food or something. I keep saying, any Muslim? Even I was speaking about Jehovah's Witnesses, and I say, any Muslim want to call me? Any Abdul? Somebody says Nadir Ahmed. Nad. This guy is a kid. Anyway, he can call me. Let him call me. Just to show you how stupid they are, those kids. If somebody says to you, I blocked him. I block people because they are kids and annoying. But he can just make a new account in 2 seconds and call me back. Can't he? You are desperate for attention? Ah, okay. Is that why I pray in the top of the car like a goat? In the corner in New York? Is that why I pray in the middle of the square where people, they are playing music? Who is the one seeking attention? It's you Muslims. Any Abdul? I remember when I was a kid, there's a kid in my age, you know, in the school. So sometimes he come to my house, I go to his house. And then in the winter, like now, his father, when he want to pray, he opened all the windows. He left all, you know, we have like, it's like a wood blind, you know, they come on the top of the window. So he left them up, he opened the windows, and then he start praying. So everybody in the neighbors will see him praying. It's cold, it's freezing. I said to him, why your dad do that? It's cold. He said, he do that only when he pray. And then his dad, he sit in the couch, and he have little rocks in the front of him. He hold one and he start hitting his head with the rock. I said, what's wrong with your dad? Why you are doing that? He says, because people will think he is praying. When he go outside, it will leave a mark in his forehead. What? This is the truth. The mark of the devil. Mark of the devil, my friend. Do you see this mark? All of them, they have it. Maybe you ask yourself, why did they have it? Did you ask yourself why? I will tell you why. Do you see it? Do you see it? The religion of hypocrisy. They want to show that he is a person who bowed down in his head a lot praying to Allah. But the fact he have little rock, he make, and now they come with a new thing. They go to Thailand and they make a tattoo which nothing can wash it. and doesn't appear like a very light tattoo. So now he do not need to pray or to hit with the rock at all. It's just a tattoo is going to stay there forever, and he is a great believer. I remember when we leave the house of this kid, you know, we go and we drink, it's Ramadan, and we are kids, you know, we eat, his mom, she have nice cookies, we eat, he eat in my house too. So we go out, and then we go, before we go out, he says, wait, I said, what? He go to the kitchen, he grabs some, he wet his lips with his tongue, and he grabbed some salt, and he put it in his tongue, and I talked to him, he said, no, which means don't talk to me, he cannot talk, because the salt will fall down. And then I said, why you are doing that? Why you put salt like this? He says, because I have to make them look dry. This is what my dad, he taught us. So they eat, they dance, they drink in their houses in Ramadan. But when they go out, they put salt in their lips to make them dry. This is a religion of hypocrisy. But in the street, everybody is fasting. Alhamdulillah, I'm fasting, brother. Alhamdulillah. Even the Prophet, he used to suck the tongue of Aisha when she is fasting. يَمُصُّ لِسَانِي, he sucked my tongue. Brother, if you suck the tongue of your wife, is that breaking the fast? Many people fast saying fake it. Okay, some fake it. Ah, okay. Let me ask you, did your Prophet fake it too? Did your Prophet fake it when he sucked the tongue of Aisha in the month of Ramadan? Like we cannot find it, the hadith here in English. We found this one, it's okay. The Prophet SAWS used to kiss her and suck her tongue when he is fasting. Is sucking liquid out of your mouth, is that a breaking the fasting for you or not? Do you see it? So I thought fasting is you are not allowed to suck any liquid, and why the Prophet is sucking the tongue of Aisha when he is fasting? Is he fasting or having sex now? And by the way, why this is even in the news? I mean, what kind of a woman she go in the street and she say, imagine I am married and my wife she go on life and say CP was sucking my tongue. Like what? A woman she say that, she must be a really a very bad woman. A decent woman, she will not tell what happened in the bedroom. Actually, Muhammad, he said that a decent woman, she will not tell what happened inside the bedroom to others. Any Muslim? Any Abdul? Let me see if I can find the hadith in English. Let us see this one. Here we go. Isn't it your Prophet, he forbid man and women to tell what happened in their bed? And he says that the one who do that, he will be punished by Allah. And then his wife, she is staying everything he do to her, including intercourse. Yeah. Anyone? I want to make your what? A ringtone? Make it ringtone, make it whatever you want. It's okay. Aisha told about because it was Islamic matter. Guys, it's Islamic matter. Let me show you Islamic matter, guys. Islamic matter is to tell somebody that you need to know that the Prophet, he used to suck the tongue of Aisha. This is Islamic matter. Well, can't Allah, he make a verse, says you can do this and this. So now Aisha is the Prophet, not Allah Prophet. You are telling me that Aisha, she is fixing something is not known in Islam, and the Prophet, he forgot to tell. So Aisha is more credible to be a prophet from the Prophet, because the one who reported this, if you are telling me you are trying, you are learning about Allah and Islam from Aisha, that means Muhammad, he did not do his job. Muhammad was busy sucking the tongue, and Aisha, she was writing down, the Prophet, he sucked my tongue. Thank you very much for the hand. Right? What constitution? Muhammad, he killed people of Medina, he killed the people of Yathrib, he took his, they took their money, he killed the Jews. What constitution? Islam never have a constitution. Islam is a religion of today is yes, tomorrow is no. Since when we have, even the Quran says, look at this, just to show you the joke or Muhammad. وَمَا نَنْسَخُ مِنْ آيَةٍ أَوْ نُنْسِهَا نَأْتِي بِخَيْرٍ مِنْهَا أَوْ مِثْلِهَا. Okay, what is that? Whatever verse we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, we bring better or similar. Like what? What is the constitution? So how you can have a constitution? Because tomorrow Allah will cause you to forget it, and Allah will bring something better or similar. Hold on. If it is going to be similar, why you are making us forget the previous one? Anyone knows what is behind this? Let me show you. The joker Muhammad, he says something in the morning, he said the opposite afternoon. So the Arab, they said, they were making fun of him. Look at this guy. He enjoy his followers an order, and he give them the opposite the second morning. Chapter 24, verse number 45. Sorry, chapter 2, verse number 106. Let me see if I can open the interpretation for you so you can read. So even their interpretation confirmed that the reason for this verse to come down, that the Arab, they were making fun of Muhammad. This guy in the morning, he says something, in the afternoon he says something else, he changed his mind and he forbid it. Not only he changed it, he forbid it. Kamala want to call me? He can call me, no problem. If he's a Muslim, he can call me. Only Muslim, please, can call me. No problem. The Muslim I debate in Indonesia said, marry as a son of Imran and the brother of Harun is the same as Jesus said, the son of David. Okay, we will answer this one. Somebody saying that he was debating a Muslim in Indonesia, and when he asked him about Mary, she is the sister of Aaron, and he said, well, the same as when you say Jesus is a son of David, but Jesus is a son of David by birth. Mary is not. Mary is not from the same tribe. Not only she is not, she is not even from the same tribe of Aaron or Moses. So there is no connection between them. Secondly, if you go to chapter number 3, what the name of the chapter? Al Imran. Do you see it? Al Imran. Okay, is Imran the father of Moses in Islam? Yes. So how Imran became the father of Mary? So not only Mary is the sister of Aaron, Mary is the sister of Aaron and she is the daughter of Imran. And this is the same person who is the father of Moses. Do you understand, my friend? So obviously, they cannot run away from a stupid mistake. It's not only she is, okay, she is the sister of Aaron. Maybe he meant something as you said, but she is the daughter of Imran. And if you go in the Bible, you will find that the father of Moses, his name is Imran. And the father of Mary, his name is not Imran. Correct? Do you see it? Yeah, but you see, this is the way to say this person is a son of the desert, no problem. But you see, your Quran saying that Imran is the father of Mary, yes or no? Is Imran the father of Mary, Mr. Proud Muslim? Either you say yes or you say no. Is Imran the father of Mary? The answer yes. Okay. Here we go. We just proved that Muhammad is a fake prophet. Imran is the father of Mary in the Quran, and he is the father of Mary of Moses, and he is the father of Aaron. And Muhammad, he claimed that Jesus and Moses and Aaron and Maryam, they are from one family, which is stupid. They are not. Chapter 3, verse number 35. When remember the wife of Imran, she said, "Oh my Lord, have vowed to you the child that in my womb." Who is the wife of who? Imran. Who is Imran? The father of Moses. And who is this woman is talking? This is the mother of Mary. So you cannot hide the stupidity. It's all over the place. Muhammad, like a person who is doing his poo-poo, and he have a diarrhea, and he have a very powerful fan behind him. And the diarrhea is all over the place. What mean different, two different Imran? First of all, Imran is the wrong name of the father of Mary. Why the Christians and the Jews, they will be, even this name will change it? Show me one reference in the world saying that Mary, she have a father, his name is Imran. Who is Imran? Secondly, is it the verse saying, the Quran saying, that those are the three from the family of Imran? This is why the verse called the family of Imran. But Moses is not. Moses and Mary, they are not from the same family. But look what happened. In the Bible, in the Torah, there's a verse saying that Harun or Aaron, he have a sister, her name is Mary, Maryam. Is that correct, guys? Is that correct? So the silly Muhammad, he heard the Jews saying, Mary, the sister of Aaron, Mary, the sister of Aaron, Mary, the sister of Aaron. So the Muhammad, he got the conclusion that Mary, the mother of Jesus, must be the sister of Aaron. Unbelievable. And when a Jewish guy, he came to Aisha and he said to her, but there's a mistake. Mary, she did not even live in the same time of Aaron. There is a couple of hundreds of years between them. Aisha, she said to the Kabul Ahbar, the guy who said that to her, she said to her, you lied, and the prophet, he told the truth. She did not say you got wrong understanding. She said to him, you're a liar. And then Muhammad come home, and she told him what this Jewish guy, he said. So Muhammad, he says, in the old days, they used to call them by the great ancestor. Now, how you can explain that Mary, her father is Amran? Anyone can explain to us how this happened? How such a mistake happened? How Amran, the same father of Moses and Aaron, became the father of Mary in the Quran? Anyone? No, there is explanation. Muhammad is a thief. Whatever the Jews he says, he take from them everything. You see, Muhammad, he and they start accusing him that you are copying from the Christians and the Jews. There's a verse in the Quran. Where Muhammad he used to go and listen to people, and they accuse him that you know, this guy obviously he is learning from those people. Look what Muhammad said. And indeed, we know that the polytheist, this is between two brackets, this is not really exist in the Quran. Say it is only a human being who teach him. So the Arab, they knew he is learning from people. The tongue, and Allah now is answering, the tongue of the man they refer to is a foreign, while this, the Quran, is a clear Arabic tongue. So what they are talking about, there was two slaves, and they are Assyrian. Or let us say Aramaic. They are coming from Iraq. And Muhammad, he sat with them and he learned from them. And they notice how much he sat and they speak about religion, and Muhammad, he listen. Why Muhammad is a prophet of God, he need to listen to those guys. Those are two slaves captured, and they are not anyone important supposedly. Why Muhammad is listening to them? So they accuse him that he is learning from them. So look at the answer. He says, well, my Quran is in clear Arabic, while those guys didn't speak with Arabic. They speak Arabic, but their Arabic is not like ours, the Arab, because they are slaves who they are captured from Iraq. So from the time of Muhammad, there was an accusation of him being a thief. And in different place, we find that Muhammad, he try always to do things different from the Jews, because everybody is laughing at him. He copied the Jews. Look what happened here. Muhammad was attending a funeral. The messenger of Allah, SAWSFFMOO shortwave, used to stand for a funeral. Entered the crops where was placed. Okay. A learned Jew. Do you see it says a learned Jew? In Arabic it says Hebron min al-Yahud, Hebron min al-Yahud, which means a big rabbi of the Jews. A big rabbi from the Jew walk by. And the big rabbi, he said, this is how we do it. What? This is how we do it. What he said? This is how we do it. And what Muhammad he said? Sit down, act differently. Sit down, act different. Look, what the heck? If Muhammad is a prophet of God, who cares if this is how they do it or not? Are you doing it according to your God or according to the Jews? But Muhammad, because he's a thief, he felt guilty immediately, because the Jews get me busted, I'm doing as they do. So immediately, in the same second, he said, sit down, act differently. And the Muslim behind him, sit down, act differently. And the guy next to the guy, he said to the other guy, sit down, because they have to spread the news. Sit down, act differently. Or what the Jew, he said, this is how we do it. And what Muhammad respond? Sit down, like, so you were praying before this moment according to who? Who taught you how to pray in the funeral like this? This hadith was labeled as what? As what? As what? And no, here we go. Here we go. This hadith, brother, is labeled as it is Hassan. If you not know what Hassan mean, go sit down, and act differently. It is Hassan. And this is your fabrication grade, because this is Sunan Abi Dawood, which is one of the Sahih books. The books of Sahih are six, and Abi Dawood is one of them. Any Abdul? And there is a great example about Muhammad trying to act differently. The story was a rumor. Guys, the story was a rumor. So if the story was a rumor, how the rumor became Hadith and Hassan, if it's a rumor? Do you see the narrator name? How a rumor, you have the narrator name. You see, when you say a rumor, it's mean you do not know who said that. Haddathana Hisham Ibn Bahram al-Mad. So, I mean, the fabrication of Muslim trying to answer is amazing. You have all the names of those who recite that. An Ibn Abi Umayyah, an Abihi, an Jiddihi, an Ubad Ibn Samit, qal, kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So how this is a rumor? You have all the names of the narrators, and yet it's a rumor? Rumor is something we do not know who said that. This is why it's called rumor. But if we know the names of all those who said and mentioned, that cannot be. What is the chain of narration? Here we go. You see, guys, the stupidity. What is the chain of narration? This is the chain of the narration in front of you. And it says, according to your scholars, not me, Hassan. So if it is a rumor, how it became with the grade of Hassan? Let me ask you, Mr. Rumor. Do you like to call me Mr. You sound like a nice guy. I like to talk to you. Mr. Waleed, do you like to call me my friend? Do you like to call me? Do you want to debate me in Arabic? You speak English. Why you want to debate in Arabic? I want everybody here. We have 1,400 at least people listening. That will be really great. If you are a person who claim you can debate me and you can stand for me, call me immediately. Do you like to debate me in Arabic? Well, you are here coming to speak in English form. And by the way, in Arabic for me is going to be more fantastic, because I do not need to suffer from translation. However, I have an offer for you. You can say whatever you want to me twice, once in Arabic and once in English. Is that fair, guys? This will give you the pleasure, double pleasure. Call me immediately, my friend. Be the man. Let everybody see that Muslims, they can answer. Are you willing to do it? Are you willing to do it? You said you want to speak in Arabic. I said, no problem. All what you need to do, give me the answer twice. One in Arabic, one in English. No problem. And let everybody laugh. What your Skype ID? I only debate in classical Arabic, just let you know. My friend, here we have English people. So people, you see, you speak English very well. And I can tell your English is very fine. Correct, guys? So what this is excuse is about? Give me your ID, I will find you. Give me your Skype ID, I will find you. We are waiting for you, Mr. Waleed. You are welcome. Invite your friends. We have Sheikh Waleed, look like he's a sheikh. Because those who says they debate in Arabic, usually they are Muslim sheikh. So we have Sheikh Waleed. is going to debate me. Please invite your friends. Things will get exciting. And this is how we do it. All right, let us see if Waleed, he sent anything. No, nothing yet. I'm waiting for you, Mr. Waleed. No, if you think Mr. Waleed is afraid to call me, you are mistaken. He will call me and he is the man. You will see. No, he will not run away. I don't think so. Are you, can you confirm, Mr. Waleed, are we going to call? Can you confirm, my friend, that you are going to call? Don't make us wait for nothing. Hello? Give me your Skype, my friend. You will have a hard time to find my Skype because many people, they copy my name. Give us your Skype. I will call you. Post your Skype. My Skype is Debate TV, but I'm telling you from now, you will have a hard time to find my Skype. Now give me your Skype. Post your ID and I will call you. And please be nice to our guest when he calls us. Be nice to him. You know, he's just a Muslim. It's not his fault. He is downloading the app. Okay, well, until he downloads the app, let us continue. All right. Some Muslim channel claiming the man in the speaker corner is you. Well, my friend, I don't live in England to go to speaker corner. And I don't do that. Anyway, they claim it's me, it's me. So, is he good looking? I hope so. If he's good looking, it's me. If he's not, it's not me. Because for once in my lifetime, I want to look good. I think this is not even fair. But what I can do. So, I don't know. It's up to you. Are you there, Waleed? He is good looking? For sure, then this is me. Are you kidding me? But come on. What happened? Waleed, why you are taking you so long to post your ID, my friend? It take you 2 seconds, post your ID for me and I will give you a call. And I'm glad that you are a sheikh who debate Christians. That's exciting. Give you 5 minutes? Okay, I will give you 5 minutes. Let me make some coffee, guys. What do you need 5 minutes? Don't make it 5 hours, please. Why you need 5 minutes, Waleed? You are going to ask for friends to come and help you? Invite everybody, brother. Everybody in the bushes. All the Muslims, you know, let them six. Actually, you need help. You will need a lot of help. I need to make some coffee, too. Should we end this broadcast and come back with a new broadcast? Just for Waleed? What do you think, guys? I don't know. Da-da-da. Don't end. Okay, I will not end. All right. Let me get something to drink. Give me a second, guys. Man, my two knee hurt from sitting all this time. You see, when I sit in the behind the computer, like, I don't know how to explain to you. I don't really relax. I'm so excited, and the excitement, it make me, like it hurt. I need to do some running. I'm running right now in front of the microphone. Getting ready for the match. Guys, I broke my toes. I will use it as an excuse not to debate Mr. Waleed. Oh, I broke my ankle. I cannot debate you now. In the Middle East, they say that somebody, he's a camel, and supposedly he have an excuse he cannot walk because he have a pimple in his lip. And I will not be surprised if Mr. Waleed he do the same. He will say, I have a pimple in my foot, so I cannot debate you. Not in his lip. Just to avoid debating me. Let me make some coffee. I'll be back.
Where's the coffee? All right, sorry guys. Am I heard? We are waiting for Mr. Wade to call us, and I'm making some Greek coffee. I love a Greek coffee. We add cardamom with it. That will taste so good. No, I have a lot of cardamom with it. And actually, I make a very good coffee. Oh boy. Isn't it 5 minutes already for Mr. Waleed? Isn't it already 5 minutes? Thank you, Ramona. Thank you. You know, once I was debating a sheikh, a Muslim sheikh. He says to me, I need to go. I said, okay, where are you going now? I mean, we are in the middle of the debate. Things are getting really hot. He said, okay, I have to tell you, I have to go to the bathroom. And that was almost 12 years ago. Never come back until now. And I was expecting maybe he fell down in the hole or something happened, or maybe because I saw a movie, a terror movie, like there's an alligator, he comes from the bathroom and he eat you. I don't know if you saw the movie, because I could not explain how the guy since 12 years ago, he went to do poo-poo and until now never come back. He just 2 minutes, like, how fast? Let me check the coffee. All right, the coffee is still in the processing. Are you there, Mr. Waleed? Thank you, Rana. Thank you. Guys, we are always victorious, not because of a Christian prince. We are victorious because we are in the right side. If the Lord is with me, who could be against me? But always before you go in a war with the devil, you should know first who is the devil and how he think. So learn and get ready, because one day you will be part of this fight. The devil will come to you. He will not leave you alone. Let me check the coffee again. Oh, boy. The smell of the coffee is beautiful. Thank you, God, for the gift. You know, I feel sorry for the Muslims. They think they have something to stand on. But the second they start speaking to someone who knows very well, they will find that what they are standing on is the sand. All right? Please, why do convert to Islam change their name from Western ones to Arabic? Because Islam is an Arabic, it's a religion made by the Arab for the Arab. So you notice that somebody who convert to Islam, right away he starts saying Arabic words, he changed his name, he dressed like Arab, he act like Arab, because Islam will strip you from your heritage. There's a hadith where Muhammad, he said, the one who is proud about his heritage, tell him to go and bite the private part of his father. All right, let me see that coffee. I hear it. Perfect. I have a. I turn off the stove so the coffee will, will boil slowly. Look what Muhammad he said about a man who is proud about his inheritance, like the heritage he have before Islam. He said to them, "The one who is proud about his inheritance
if someone cancel people in the way of the people cancel each in the days of Jahiliyyah. Jahiliyyah mean the ignorance, which is in the Arab time before Muhammad. Look what the Muslim translation is, which is false. And as long as Mr. Walid, he will call me soon, I will make him. You gave me your Skype? Okay, where is your Skype? Can you post it again, please? Mr. Walid, can you post it again? Anyone saw the post of Walid Skype? Guys, please, no need to call him coward. The guy is calling us. Please stop doing that. Walid, what is your Skype? I don't see it. Okay, this is your Skype. Well, I hope I will find this name, because Skype ID is not a name. It should be like there's numbers, letters. Anyway, let us see if we can find you, my friend. All right, I found you. All right. Give me a second, I'll get my coffee and I will call you. All right, please invite your friends. We are going to call our friend here. His name is Walid, and supposedly he is speaking to me from Saudi Arabia, as I see in his Skype. That's fantastic. All right, Mr. Walid, I send you hi. Shalom, my friend, and I will call you.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Are you Christian Prince?
Yes, I'm fine, my friend. Go ahead. What do you want to say to us?
Christian Prince?
Yes, I hear you. Go ahead. You are live on air. Go ahead. Are you trying to make me to hear the Adhan? Is that the purpose of your call? Hello? Do you want to debate me? Hello? So all of this for a guy, he is using the internet of the neighbor? Hello? Make us get excited. I made coffee. I send my four wives in vacation. Turn to be what? The guy, he don't even have an internet. He's in the internet of the neighbors. Are you there, Walid? He's gone. Okay, I will hang up. Call him again. Okay. Too bad. Well, we will give him a chance. Maybe he can fix it. Maybe he can find a better neighbor internet. No. Let us hope so. The internet of the neighbor is very popular in the Middle East because nobody, I mean, they are very, very decent countries, you know. No, no, he's not a GG. Please translate all your books to Arabic so that we could gift to Arab friends. That would be funny, by the way, to translate my books into Arabic. I prefer to make them in Arabic because translating to Arabic is not really a solution. Writing the book in Arabic is way easier. You see, if I'm writing a book in Arabic, it's going to take me not even 10% of the time it takes me to write a book in English, because English is not my first language. The text I'm reading is not in not in English. So I have to translate my words and the words which is in the books, and that will take a lot of time, grammar, mistakes, etc. So, Mr. Waleed, are you there? Yeah, Abdul Mati. Let us call him again. This guy, he think he have knowledge of Islam. You will see. I hope his microphone will work. You will see in 2 minutes that he have no idea what he's talking about. Yeah, look like he have a very bad internet. What we can do? We wait for him to call back. But didn't you know that your internet is bad when you said to me you want to challenge me? I don't know, it sounds fishy. It sounds really fishy. Because I'm assuming that you know what kind of internet you have. Yeah, you have a da'if internet, da'if. The internet is da'if, Allah is da'if, the Prophet is da'if, the Hadith is da'if. Everything is da'if in this cult. Even when they go with the war with Israel, they are da'if. Nader Ahmed, he tried to debate me. Okay, if you have Nader Ahmed, let him call me now. Just for a laugh. He try. This guy, he admit that his prophet have sex with that goat. What debate me about what? This guy's a kid. He's a stupid. He's a madman. That's why I don't like to talk to people who they have a stupidity. Otherwise, he don't even know how to say his prophet name correctly. Like, why you don't bring me somebody is qualified to be to defend Islam? You Muslims, you are very funny. This guy don't even have high school, not only in Islam, and even in a normal high school. So from all the Muslims who have beard and blah, 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 you get me just a kid. Who agreed that his prophet have, he said, so what's wrong is the prophet have, isn't it better if the prophet have sex from somebody saying smash the head of the baby? This is the best you have? Okay, bring him, okay, let him call me. So we can love, no problem. Any Muslim, he have a microphone and he have a headset and he have internet from the neighbor, he can call me. What do you think? And nobody can track me, don't worry about my IP address. This is not my IP address is not my IP address. I'm using the net of the neighbor. Just joking. Okay. I fixed my internet because I did not hear you. Okay, he fixed it now. I will call back in 2 minutes. Okay, that's good. Guys, he fixed his internet. That's wonderful. Have patience. We have the army doing training in our town here. A lot of airplanes coming down, going up, going on. Make me feel excited. Anyone join? Anyone but was in the army before? Okay, 2 minutes is over, my friend Waleed. I'm waiting for long. Anyone would like to help Mr. Waleed, you can call us. He was in the army, Tyler. And I did join the army of ants once. And what happened at that time, I was with the army of the ants, and Solomon, he came. And one of the ants, which was, as I remember, she was a sergeant, she said, hide, otherwise Solomon is going to crush you. You don't believe me? Here we go. And the value of the ants, by the way, is you can find it in Google Map. You can find it in Google Map. It's very, I mean, there's a, yeah, it's a true story. Till I was there at that moment, you see, they are, this is, I enter history by mistake. Till when they came to the valley of the ants, one of the ants said, oh ants, I like it when ants speak. So look, they say, oh ants, they don't say ants, oh ants. You know, do you know the song? It says, oh mommy, mommy blue. Okay, oh ants, enter, you're doing last, Suleiman or Solomon and his host will crush you. That's amazing. That's so good. But as I know, ants don't talk, my friend. How she said? What do you mean she said? And Suleiman, he was amused with her speech, which means he heard the speech. But ants are deaf. Truth hurt when I call me. He can call me. Any Muslim would like to call, feel free, my friend. I'm here just to talk to you. No problem. You don't need permission. As long as you are a Muslim, as long as you are a Muslim, just call me. You do not need permission. Doesn't matter who you are. Let's call Mr. Waleed again. See if it's going to work. Look like it's working.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, Mr. Waleed. How are you?
Kafali.
Hello?
Khair, can you hear me?
Sorry?
Could you print?
Yes, I hear you. Go ahead.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
I hope my internet is better.
Yeah, it's better. You said that you debate people in Arabic. Is that right? Usually?
Yeah.
But do you speak Arabic?
Classical Arabic.
But do you speak Arabic?
Classical Arabic.
You speak classical Arabic?
Hello?
Yeah, you speak classical Arabic?
Muslim friends.
I hear you. So do you
Are
speak?
You there?
I'm here. Do you speak classical Arabic, my friend? Here we go. Speak classical Arabic. Okay. Look like it's not working. Let us call him again. What we can do, we are desperate trying to find somebody to call us. That's what happens when you are homeless. All right. Who is next? Who is a Muslim? He is willing to call us, please. He debate in a classical Arabic. I guarantee you, he don't know how, what to say anything. I mean, you will see. If he call me, I will say to him, debate me in a classical Arabic. I want to hear it. Yeah. My friend, truth heart, he want to call me. Let him call me. What I can do? Okay, truth heart. Call me, truth heart. Go ahead. And what I can do more? You want to call me? Call me. Are you there, Mr. Truthheart? Let me invite you, like a long invitation. Maybe you like long. Truthheart, you are welcome to call me. Truthheart, don't hesitate to refute me. Truthheart, call me before the end she come to me. truth heart. Suleiman, amused by your challenge to me. Okay, I'm waiting. I mean, what I can do more? I made just a song just for him. He entered history now. Muhammad, he will take it, he will make a Quran. So don't tell me again, truth heart, when I call me. Anyone as a Muslim, call me. Who is a Muslim, want to call me? Your bad sound? What bad sound? My voice is bad? Really? Now I know. I applied to work as a singer. They said to me, no. Throat coat, horrible, many, vitamin D3, 500 XD, no caffeine. No. Yeah, I know. My friend said the coffee. I drank too much coffee. I'm working in a book. So, because I'm staying for many hours writing. Don't worry about my guys. What's the problem? So if my voice is not good, you will not like it now? Are you here because of my voice or because of what I say? Yeah, I will punish you all. I will sing. All my life, I wanted to be a singer. hold on. You see, I'm not lucky. I wanted to sing. Here we go. Hello?
Christian Prince.
Yes, Mr. Wade. Go ahead, please. Go ahead in the talk.
Kif khalak.
My friend, there is nothing in Arabic. It's called kif khalak. Khalak in Arabic means your uncle. So when you say kif khalak, you are asking me, how is your uncle? Oh, boy. He lost it. Kif khalak. He's asking me kif khalak. Khalak in Arabic means how is your uncle? He's fine, by the way. Which one? There's like 40 of them. And he want to debate me in Arabic. And he says to me, kif khalak. Oh boy. That reminds me of Elijah. I mean, God is with us. Yeah, 40. Why you are surprised? My grandfather, one in one, but this is a long time ago. And we have one lunch. We have 96 male, just male, over the age of 18, and they are just from one grandfather. Over the age of 18, we are not counting boys, little children, or girls. No. Just male, who they are grandsons of one grandfather, 96. Only. Yeah. So anyway, any Muslim want to call us? Yeah, we can, by now, they pass already, they passed the 200, I guess. But this is all the news. I mean, I was at that time, we count them. You know, I was a kid too. I was like, you know. So any Muslim would like to call us? Yeah, this is why when people, they invite me to come, I say, can I come with my cousins? They have no idea what they are talking about. So they say, yes, sure. Oh, boy. All right. So where is the Muslims who want to call us? Anyway, so as long as there's no Muslims to call us, sadly, what we can do. But as you see, Islam is a very silly, stupid cult. All what you need to know is just to study it very well, and you will find that this is just nothing but a collection of fairy tale stories. How in the world anyone who believe in God would believe in such a story? That there is a guy, his name is Suleiman, and he have an army of a chicken and genie and mankind. And if you don't believe me, the Quran says that, chapter 27, verse number 17. I mean, this is God speaking about his prophet Solomon.
Or this is Muhammad copying the Jews' legends, which they used to tell their kids about Solomon. Muhammad the thief, he copied what the Jews did tell to their children about the great King Solomon, the great King David, you know, and there's tons of fiction stories. There's a book, it's called The Legends of the Jews. You can go and search it in the internet, and you will find that this story exists there. And this is where Muhammad, he got his story from. I will give you another example about Muhammad the thief. If you remember Muhammad, he spoke about the punishment of the grave. Look at this, Muhammad saying, and this is Sahih, that the cause of the punishment of the grave is the urine. What is the urine? Where Muhammad is getting this? He got it from the Jews. The Jews, they are very clean people. And in order to make somebody, especially the kids, to clean themselves, not to, like when they pee, they don't, you know, the pee should not touch their skin. They say to them, you will be punished in the grave if you do that. And the guy, he said, Mom, okay, I will not do that. So Muhammad, he heard the Jews saying that. And Muhammad, he copied it as it is, as usual. And I will show you the proof of that, that Muhammad is nothing but a thief. Let us see. Okay. Where Aisha and the Jewish women, they fight about it. There's a hadith. Here we go. And this is a sahih hadith too. A Jewish woman entered into me, Aisha's talking, which means to her house, and said, the torment of the grave is because of urine. Because of what? Because of urine. I said, you're lying. Aisha, she is smarter than this. So she don't believe in that. So she said, no, it's true. The Jewish woman, she said, no, it's true. We cut our skin and the clothes because of it. The messenger of Allah went out, which means from his room, and to pray, and he heard our voices become loud. So he said, what is this? What's happening? So I told him that what she had said, that's the punishment of the grave, most of it is from the urine. He said, she spoke the truth. Oops. Muhammad, he took the side of the Jewish woman. She spoke the truth. And look what Aisha, she said, exposing the liar Muhammad. And she said, Aisha, after that day, he never offered any prayer, but he said, following the prayer, Rabba Jibreel wa Mikael wa Israfil, adding, saying, protect us from the punishment of the grave. Do you see it? So Muhammad never mentioned the punishment of the grave before. Never, ever. Since he heard the Jew saying that to Aisha, he never offered a prayer unless he add, I seek refuge by Allah from the punishment of the grave. Muhammad Ayyub Ahad, he's saying free Palestine. Okay, my friend, this guy, he hate Allah. Because according to the Quran, it says that Allah is the one who gave Palestine to the Jews. Let me get you busted. No, don't block him. He's a poor guy. Here we go. According to your God, Allah, he assigned the land which is called Palestine to the Jews. So are you striking against Allah or against Israel, brother? Because the one who strike against Israel, he is striking against Allah and the proof in front of you. Do you see it? Shall I say takbir or you say takbir? Say takbir. You take a beer, I take coffee.
Why Allah, he gave the land to the Jews? He never even mentioned the word Palestine, brother. And look in the translation, they put between two brackets, Palestine. Oh my people. Hello.
Salam alaikum.
Hey, Waleed, are you going to talk?
I see flat to kill him for Saharabi.
You don't speak Fassa, Fassa Arabi? You don't speak Fassa Arabi. Do you know what Fassa mean? Fassa is the grass they give to the goat. So he don't speak Fassa Arabi. And the funny, he was challenging me to debate in Arabic. I don't speak Fassa Arabi. Oh boy. You don't speak Fassa? Do you speak Hassa? ايش رايك تحكي انت فصه وانا احكي حصه وكل واحد يفصفص على كيفه فصفص لي وانا فصفص لك شنو هذا and he speak Arabic he want to debate me like when you hear this I thought this guy is a big sheikh he want to debate me in Arabic but he must be a big sheikh and by the way he have a beard in his picture oh boy ايه التخلف ده انت بتشتم التخلف يلا طب حوريك لو كان ما فيش تخلف حنعمل ايه حنتفرج على ايه حنضحك على ايه يا راجل يا راجل ارحم anyway any Muslim would like to call us Any Muslim? Heavy accent? Heavy accent? Wherever I go, they say to me, where are you from? I don't tell them just for their safety. Because the second I say where I'm from, everybody want to leave the chair next to me in the airplane. Nobody want to sit next to me. Actually, it's useful. You will have the seat by yourself. Anyone? Thank you, Light. I'm just joking with you, my friend. The only teacher we have is the Messiah, our Lord, and no one else. Here we share what we learn, and all wisdom it come from his mouth. Otherwise, we have no wisdom. The man speak foolishness. If we don't have a guideline where we can find wisdom and where we can get our wisdom, we will never get. This is why the Lord, he says, read the books. You see, the Lord, he wants us not to be ignorant. Ignorance is our enemy. It's not the Muslims. The enemy of all mankind is ignorance. Muslims, their enemy number one is their ignorance. They think that this is God. They think Allah is God and Muhammad. Read and love. This is God. This is God. God, he believed that there is an army given to Suleiman and there is a bird, a chicken. Why Suleiman, he needed an army of birds? Where Muhammad did not have this army? He needed, he's doing jihad. Give him an army of birds. This guy, are you serious? This guy is saying to me, call me when you are back. As if I am the one who left. Call me when you are back. What are you talking about? It is you who hang up. Okay. It says missed call. Oh, okay. Hello?
Yalla. Yalla.
Yes, my friend, you keep hanging up. I'm not the one who did not call you. I mean, here we go. Go ahead. What do you want to say to us?
My internet was very bad.
Okay, what I can do. My friend, did you say inshallah before you call me? You should say inshallah, because if you don't say inshallah, there's a prophet who had want to have sex with 99 women, but he forgot to have to say inshallah. So Allah, he gave him a half a child. Do you know the story?
Yes.
Okay, why is that? Why Allah he gave him he gave him half a child? He forgot to say inshallah.
Solomon.
Mm-hmm.
الحديث ضعيف.
ضعيف. It's ضعيف, but this is a story in the Quran, my friend.
لا.
شوف. شو نشوف؟ Don't you listen? Here we go. It says a chapter 38, verse number 23, that my brother he have 99 goats.
Al Quran.
Yes, in the Quran.
Show me.
Show you. I'm showing you. Here we go. I said, just told you, chapter 38, verse number 23.
Okay. Chapter 32.
38, verse number 23.
Okay.
Hmm.
Opening now.
All right. That's wonderful.
Internet very bad.
Very bad. Very bad. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
You speak Arabic?
No, I speak German. Option Achschmacht.
You said you are Arab.
My friend, answer. I just gave you a question. What does have to do? Yes, I'm an Arab. Yes.
So how come you don't speak Arabic?
I was in the like plane with the kids, and somebody hit me in my head. Like what happened to your prophet? He lost his four teeth in the front, so I lost my front teeth and I lost my memory. Now what about you? Do you speak Arabic?
Shwaya.
So what you said to me, you want to debate me in Arabic if you don't speak Arabic?
I speak classical Arabic. Very good.
Okay, now what do you say about what we see in front of us, that this prophet he's saying he is calling his wives as goats and he want to have sex with all of them so they will have children and he will do jihad?
I'm reading verse 38 to 23.
Read verse. Okay.
Indeed, this my brother has 99 wives and I have one wife, so he said in trust. What has this to do?
Well, I'm asking you.
This is not relevant.
This is not relevant. Why not relevant? You said to me that this hadith is weak, but this is as I know, this is not weak. This is Quran, first of all.
Chapter 38, verse 23.
Is that you said to me this is weak? Who told you that this is weak?
But what is this? Indeed, this my brother has 90.
Okay, so this guy want to have sex with 99 women, 100 women, less one, and he want to make them have babies so he can do jihad. And here we go. This is the hadith. This is a da'if hadith. What do you think? It's da'if hadith. What do you think? It says that the son, Solomon's sons, the prophet David said, tonight I will go around and I will have boom boom with 100 women of my wives, every one of them whom will deliver a male child, so I will do jihad for the cause of Allah. But he forgot to say, here we go, it says, and on that the angel said to him, say if Allah will. But Solomon did not say if it is, he did not say it. So Allah, he gave him half a child. Explain to me the story. This is the Eve hadith.
Ism Habibi.
What Habibi?
The word, darling. The word there for wives is Naja.
Naja. Naja mean goat.
Yes, but it doesn't mean wives in Arabic.
So you are saying that Solomon, he was having sex with goats?
It doesn't mean the word for wife is
listen. So are you saying that Solomon was having sex with goats, not with wives? Because you say this is not wives, but in Arabic it says Naja mean goats. So are you saying that he was having sex with goats?
My friend, it is a language of Arabic that you don't understand.
At that time they called their wife a goat. How many goats do you have at home?
No, wait. It doesn't say that he had sex.
Okay.
It says he entrusted her. Look.
Listen. Okay, this is, let me show you the hadith, my friend. The hadith said, the hadith, let me show you here the hadith. It said that he said, I'm going to have sexual intercourse with them. Read with me carefully. Do you see my screen?
No.
Okay, it says the Prophet Solomon, the son of the Prophet David, said, no problem, I'm reading for you. Listen, I'm reading. So he said, tonight I will go around, i.e. have boom boom sexual intercourse with 100 women of my wives, every one of whom will deliver a male child. The angel said to him, say inshallah, if Allah will. But Solomon did not say that, he forgot to say it. Then when he had boom boom sexual intercourse with his wives, none of them deliver any child except one. She gave him a half person. What does that mean? Go ahead.
Well, you got to look at the narration.
What is the chain of the narration? Okay. And what is that? What does that mean? This is da'if hadith. This is da'if.
I'm not saying that.
No, you said that already. You told me it's da'if. You forgot. You have a short memory, my friend. Hit your head again. You said to me this is da'if.
Because the chain of the narrator.
So this is da'if. This is da'if. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, but this is Sahih Bukhari.
You can say that, but you have to prove.
Sahih Bukhari is da'if now. Sahih Bukhari is da'if.
I don't see your screen.
Here we go. I will give you the link. No problem. This is Sahih Bukhari.
Internet is
hadith
bad.
Hadith number. No problem. Sahih Bukhari. Hadith number 5242.
I'm calling you from my phone. Not
I don't
from,
care. William, no problem. I will give you the link. Here we go. I will give you the link. No problem.
Okay.
Don't forget to say inshallah before you open it, because it's not going to open if you don't say inshallah.
What happened
to Suleiman? He have sex with 99 women and then Allah deliver him half a child. What does that mean, half child? Do you know what half child mean?
Yeah.
What does that mean, half child?
Premature.
So is Allah punishing Suleiman, giving him half a child?
No, premature. Read the Arabic.
Do you understand Arabic?
Yeah.
Okay, open the link. I gave you the link in Arabic and read it for us. Let us see if you read Arabic. Go ahead.
Let me go. I did not receive anything.
No, I gave you a link, my friend. Don't tell me you did not. Click at the chat.
What
say again? What say again? What is the first word?
Hadathani.
What is that? Let me read it for you. Okay, I will help you. No problem. You don't know Arabic. Don't lie next time. Say you speak Arabic. Hadathani Mahmud, Hadathana Abdul Razzaq, Akhbarana Muammar, An Ibn Tawus. Do you know Ibn Tawus?
Is your cousin. Yeah, Tawus, exactly.
Are you not Tawus? Ibn Tawus is your cousin. What Tawus mean?
Tell me. You claim to speak Arabic.
Well, Tawus is a bird, have many colors in his wings.
Are you serious?
I'm very serious.
Go to the Arabic dictionary.
Here we go. I will just search in Google and you will see that the word Tawus will show you the bird. Here we go. You see it? Okay, this is Tawus.
Let's open your channel. I don't see it.
This is the Tawus.
Let me try.
Give
me 1 second. I'm opening your YouTube channel.
Ah, okay.
1 second.
Uh-huh.
You know, internet here very bad.
I understand. The internet is very bad. Islam is da'if. Hadith is da'if. Quran is da'if. Internet is da'if. Anything the Muslim touch is da'if. Yeah, Israel is strong. Okay.
I see. Now I see. I see bird.
This is the bird. This is Tawus. You said to me, are you serious?
My friend, copy the word, put it in dictionary. Let's everybody see what the word means.
Okay, here we go. So I will copy the word. I will put it for you in dictionary. All right.
In front of my eyes.
In front of your eyes. No problem. Here we go. Just wait. Hold on. Let me open the dictionary site. All right.
Internet very bad here.
The internet is very bad, for sure, very bad.
Very hot, you know, outside.
Okay, here we go. This is the dictionary. And I will put the word Taus.
Mm-hmm.
It's a name of a bird. Here we go. Do you see it?
Yeah.
Hmm. So?
Yeah. What it means? Yes, but you know, Arabic it can mean many different things.
It can mean many different things. You know, my friend, I want to learn. Okay, what is the other meaning for the word Taus? I'm listening.
We use the Taus for, you know, for many different birds.
Okay, give me what other meaning for Taus. We showed you that Taus is the name of a bird. Now, what is that?
It can also mean hills.
Hills?
No, hills.
Hills, yeah. Mean Taus?
No. Hills for women. You know, women when they were hills.
Really? Man. Yes. My friend, aren't you the one who says to me, show me dictionary?
Yes, Taus mean...
Okay, well, this is the dictionary. The dictionary says this is what it's mean. Read carefully. Hmm? This is what dictionary is saying, and not me.
Internet is very bad.
Okay, my friend, let's go to the topic. So, Suleiman, obviously, you do not know what are you talking about. So, Suleiman, he wanted to have sex with 99 women who the Quran described him as goats. And then he forgot to say the word inshallah. And then Allah, he gave him a half a child. Why this has happened to Suleiman?
Well, because he forgot to say inshallah.
Well, Christian men, all men, the Hindus, the Buddhas, they don't say Allah at all when they have sex, and they don't say Allah at all unless they want to laugh at something comedy. So how come they have a full child, but the one who is a prophet of Allah, he forgot to say inshallah, Allah gave him half a child?
Because he was ignorant, you know.
He was ignorant. So are you saying because you are ignorant, Allah will punish your son, he will make him half son? What is the fault of this little baby? You did nothing wrong. Allah is punishing Suleiman or punishing the baby now?
You know, because you have to obey him. If you don't obey him, you know, there's
so obey him what? So if I don't obey Allah, Allah will make you have a half son?
Not half. The word there is premature.
What premature? Where it says here in Arabic, it says nusfu insan. It doesn't say premature. Nusf. Not the word nusf in Arabic mean half.
Yeah, premature, but
it says nusf. It doesn't say premature. It says nusf, half a human. This is what nusf mean. Nusf mean half. Now, let us say it's a premature, as you said. Okay. I don't say inshallah at all. I am against the will of Allah. And there's millions and hundreds of millions of people like me. But they have, you know, I'm not married, so I cannot speak about myself, but they have kids, and their kids is not half a child, as the story tell. Actually, your prophet father himself, he was not a Muslim, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so how Muhammad is not a half a human being? The father of Muhammad, he was not a Muslim. He did not say inshallah. So Muhammad was a half man and half donkey, or one full human?
I want to ask you something.
Ask me something, but why you don't answer about this before you ask me something? You can ask me a lot of something.
I will answer you one second. You said in many of your videos that
don't change the topic. Answer me about this something, and then you can ask me about the other something.
No. We go back.
No problem. You can go back later. Why want to go back if you can tell me right now? Tell me, Muhammad's father, he did not say inshallah before he have sex with his mother. So why Muhammad is not half a human?
How do you know?
Because Muhammad, he says his father will go to hell. He is not a believer.
Where is this?
I saw it in the magazine.
Is this your claim or
my claim? Yeah. What do you think? Why would my claim?
Well, your claim is your claim. It doesn't mean that is the truth.
Okay, but what if I approve it?
You cannot.
I cannot. Are you sure?
Well, let's see.
No, I'm saying, what if I claim it? What will happen?
You have to show it to me from if you show to me from Sahih source, you shut me up. If you show me from Sahih source, if you show me from Daif or Hassan, you know, not acceptable.
Okay, well, here we go. The Hayat in front of us. What you will say?
You send it to me on Skype. I don't see your channel. Give me 2 seconds. I'll open
it. But the problem is Daif. But the problem is Daif. What we will do now is Daif. It says, a man asked, "Where is my father?" Messenger of Allah said, "Your father in hell." When he turned his back, he said, the Prophet, "My father and your father in hell." But is Daif, what he can do now? Do you think this is rejected now?
Of course.
Okay,
of
but course. It is Daif, but of course, but it is Sahih. But it is Sahih. What we will do now?
Where does it say Sahih?
It says Sahih there.
Where?
It says there.
Send it to me on Skype.
Okay, I will send it to you on Skype.
I can go back to the to other topic.
Yeah, we are in the topic. So you said to me, the Prophet, this is the topic. I mean, either you agree, either you agree that the story you are giving me is a stupid, or you agree that this Muhammad is a liar.
Al-Albani.
Is it Sahih or not?
It's Al-Albani.
What Al-Albani? This is, first of all, this is Sunan Abi Dawood. The whole book is authentic. It is authentic book. The books of Sahih are 6, and this is your Muslim website. And the grade of it,
who said
is Sahih.
Who said it's Sahih?
I said that because I learned that from universities. Do you have an Islamic degree? No. I do. So the books of Sahih are 6, and one of them is Sunan Abi Dawood.
I know.
Okay, no, you do not know. Don't tell me you know. You know nothing. Now answer. So you're a prophet, father. He's in hell because he's not a believer. So he did not say inshallah. Now we go back to zero. So why Sulaiman? Because he did not say inshallah. Allah, he gave him half a child. What happened?
Wait. It says a man asked to what is my father? But this is not the prophet talking.
No, the prophet talking.
But a man asked.
Yeah, the man he asked the prophet, and the man he's gone. So Muhammad, he says to him, because yeah, he got upset.
Oh my God, the dab, listen.
Huh?
He says, just read English, okay? Read.
Uh-huh.
A man asked, uh-huh. A man, yes, uh-huh. Where is my father, uh-huh. Messenger of Allah?
Okay.
So a man asked the messenger, uh-huh. And the messenger said, your father is in hell. So he's not talking about his father, he's talking about the father of the man.
But he said,
you understand
my father and your father.
Yeah, but those are the translators putting it there. It's not in a...
the translators.
You are playing games.
Okay, I'm playing games. Okay, let us see. What about this hadith?
Let me try open YouTube. 1 second. Can you still hear me?
Yeah, I hear you. What about this hadith here?
Good. I'm opening YouTube right now.
Okay.
Because I don't trust you.
Or no, don't trust me. I don't trust myself, my brother. I ate too much falafel.
Falafel, yeah. Hummus.
Yeah. Now answer. Does it say that your prophet is the one who says, "Verily, my father and your father in hellfire"?
Yes.
Yes. So why are you lying to me?
I was wrong.
Okay. All right. Now, so we go back to zero.
Let me ask you.
So you're a prophet. You're a prophet. His father did not say inshallah, obviously, before he do boom boom. So now, why Sulaiman, his children became half a children when Sulaiman is a believer and he wanna even do jihad. He wanna have kids so he can do kill Christians and Jews. So why Allah is giving him half a child just because he forgot to say inshallah? But you're a prophet, father. He did not say inshallah at all, yet he gave him half Muhammad.
Let me ask you a question, okay? I answered the question. Now
you ask me. You answer me nothing. Until now, I'm waiting for the first question. Why? This is the question. Why Allah did that to Sulaiman, did not do that to Muhammad?
Let me ask you a question, okay?
Okay. So you wanna? So just say it. I have no answer. Just say it.
Say it, and I'll let you ask me the question.
No.
Don't change topic. If you say I don't have an answer, I give up. Okay, no problem. Otherwise, answer, and you can ask me the question.
I will explain to you.
No, answer the question. Don't explain. I don't want explanation. I want an answer. So why this is happening to Suleiman? He forgot to say inshallah. But there's millions of people don't say inshallah at all, including the father of Muhammad, and nothing happened to them. Go ahead.
I don't know. To be honest, I think the
thank you. Finally, he said, I don't know. Now hit me with the question you have. So he do not know, guys. The guy who claimed he know nothing. Okay, thank you for being honest, at least. So now, what is your question?
I said, I don't know who put the story there. You know,
what do you mean, who put the story there? Are you telling me are you going to say to me I wasn't there? Are you saying to me you wasn't there? Well, your prophet is the one who said the story, and this is authentic.
The story looks fabricated.
But I showed you Quran. Okay, explain to me the Quran. Explain to me the Quran, chapter 38, verse number 23. It says that this is my brother, he have 99 goats. Explain to me this verse. Who is the one is talking, and who are the goats? Here we go. This is Quran.
Let me ask you something.
No, don't ask me for something, because I said to you, in order to ask me something, you have to admit that you are an ignorant, you have no answer. You see, you play the game that the hadith is weak, and it's not. We showed you it is sahih. Now we are showing you Quran. So chapter 38, verse number 23, it says, my brother, he have 99 wives.
I explained to you already. They are goats.
Huh?
I explained already.
What
the word? The word for goat there.
Okay, but what is the story is about? Who is talking and what 99? What he's talking about? What is about? Explain to me what is behind the story.
I told you the word for wife is in Arabic. Mm. We say zawaj. It is not, there. Do you see the word zawaj there? I don't see the word zawaj.
And?
Well,
what is the answer? I'm asking you for the answer now. What this is behind? What is behind this story here?
Do you see the word zawaj there?
What zawaj? No, it's not there. No.
So?
Okay. So you tell me, I'm asking you. Don't tell me so. You tell me what is the meaning. Tell me the story. Go ahead.
I don't know the story, to be honest.
So what you are, so admit that you do not know. Just say it.
I don't know.
Okay, you do not know. Now, so guys, finally he admit that he's ignorant. Now give me your question. Go ahead.
So you, in many of your videos, you say the word Allah means moon god. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. You say the word Al means in English the. Correct?
In Arabic, not in English.
Oh yes, in Arabic. Okay.
Yeah.
It means the.
No.
Okay.
Two meaning. No, the word Al, it has two meaning, which is.
I know. Don't teach me Arabic. I know Arabic better.
No, you don't speak Arabic. Okay, speak to me Arabic. Go ahead.
You speak classic Arabic.
I speak any Arabic you wish in the world. Go ahead. Speak to me in Arabic.
You don't speak. Speak to me classic Arabic.
Speak to me in Arabic. Any. It's just speak to me Arabic. Go ahead. Prove to me your point in Arabic. Go ahead.
Okay, you don't know Arabic. Okay, so the word Al.
No. Speak to me in Arabic. Give me the answer in Arabic. Just to show everybody that you are a liar, you don't speak Arabic. Go ahead. Give me the answer in Arabic first and then say it in English. Go ahead.
Don't embarrass yourself in front of me, okay?
Give me the answer in Arabic.
Don't embarrass yourself, my friend.
Give me the answer in Arabic.
You know, in Arabic, okay, let me explain.
No, give me that. You said you speak Arabic. I said, don't embarrass yourself in Arabic. Let's see who's going to be embarrassed. Give me the answer in Arabic. Go ahead.
You don't speak classical Arabic.
Give me the answer in Arabic.
You don't speak classical Arabic.
My friend, people will see in a second. Go ahead. Let's see who speak, who don't speak. Go ahead. Speak to me in the classical Arabic. Go ahead. Give me the answer in the classical Arabic.
You start. You claim you speak classical Arabic. You speak to me. I'm waiting.
What do you mean speak? Okay. هذا المتحدث معي حمار ابن حمار وفي رأسه رسن. Here we go. I spoke to you in Arabic and now I want you to prove me wrong.
What is this, my friend? Is this classical Arabic?
Yes, translate what I said. Can you translate what I said?
Oh my God. This classical Arabic.
Yes. This is okay. I will give you. Okay, hold on, guys. This guy. Yes. He don't agree that I said classical Arabic. Okay. I will say to you. Hold on. والوالدات يرضعن أولادهن حولين كاملين. Is that a classical Arabic or not?
That's try not to fart. Try not to fart.
You said this is fart. This is Quran. You eat it. I was reading Quran for you. This is Quran. Here we go. This is the chapter 2, verse number 233. I was reading Quran for you. And you said try not to fart. Everybody heard you.
You're scared. See, you're scared.
Everybody heard you. I was reading Quran in the classical Arabic. وَالْوَالِدَاتُ يُرْضِعْنَ أَوْلَادَهُنَّ حَوْلَيْنَ كَامِلَيْنَ. And you said to me, don't fart.
My friend, you're not Arab. Listen. Let me ask you my question.
Just,
okay, don't be scared.
Just,
okay.
Get lost. We spanked you as enough. You don't speak Arabic. An Indonesian guy is telling me, to me, you don't speak Arabic.
Why you hang up to my face?
Because you are stupid. Okay, are you going to speak to me in Arabic or not? I challenge you to speak to me in Arabic.
Why you hang up to my face?
Speak in Arabic. Otherwise, don't waste my time. I want to speak to you in Arabic only. Classical language. Go ahead.
I don't hear you for some reason.
Listen. What? Why you hang up? What? Don't go. Don't go. Speak to me. Give me the answer in Arabic, please.
Can you stop being scared?
Give me the answer in Arabic. You claim that you speak Arabic. You are a liar. You don't speak Arabic. And you accuse me that I am reading Quran and you call it fart. Shame on you. You called the Quran fart. How dare you? How dare you? I was reading the Quran. I was reading the Quran, chapter 2, verse number 2.
My friend, you speak.
Don't tell me your friend. I'm asking you. Did I read the Quran for you and you said stop farting? I was reading the Quran for you, chapter 2, verse number 233. So why you said stop farting?
I was referring to the things you said before.
No, you said the word farting after I did read this.
Listen, let me ask you something.
Ask me something.
You said the word. Don't be scared. Let me ask my question, okay?
Okay.
Because you said you cannot refute me. You said the word Allah means Al means the and Lach is the name of the moon god, correct?
Uh-huh, yeah.
Okay. If my name is Theodore, does that mean that my name is Odor? You understand me?
You are very smart. Abdul,
I'll type.
Okay, you said you speak Arabic, right? Can you read for me this word in the screen?
I don't see. So okay.
Read for me. The second word, the second name of Allah in the Quran, the second name. The second time, Rahman. The second time the word Allah mentioned in the Quran, verse number 2 in chapter number 1. And verse number 1, chapter number 1. What the difference between them? What the difference between them?
The Aleph. The Aleph.
Okay, why the Aleph is missing?
Oh my God. Let me teach you Arabic, okay?
Okay, teach me Arabic.
In Arabic language for grammar, the word Al means the. Okay? The. It is.
Okay. So guys, the word Al means the. So thank you very much. So the word that, let us type it there, so you don't change your mind later. So if we say here, the first word Allah, when you say in the name of Allah, you are saying the la. The la. Thank you.
Listen, you just
proved my point.
Look.
So Allah, your God name is not Allah, your God name is la.
See, look. look in the chat, everybody. Look.
My friend, if my name is Theodore, I want an answer. No, this is the name of God. What Theodore? Are you stupid or what? This is Arabic. And now I want you to answer. You just admitted that the first two letters in the name of your God, you just admitted, everybody heard you, that the first two letters, the first two letters in the name of your God, according to you, is the. You said that, not me. The, la. So what the name of your God?
We don't understand.
You said that, not me. I'm just going with you. You are the one who said to me, do you know what the first two letters? You said, yes, the first is that. This is I said to you, why in the Allah, in the second verse, this appeared the Aleph? I said, what the difference between them? You said to me, the Aleph. Okay, I said, so why? You said, because the first two letters in the first one is that, equal to that. So the name of your God is La. And what is La? We can search right now in Google. We'll find that La is the moon God.
See how stupid you are. See.
Well, I am if I am stupid, teach me. Isn't you who says to me the name of your God is Dala?
You're not letting me talk. You're not letting me talk.
The second one, okay. In the second one, why the Aleph disappear? What we have? It says Lillah. Do you agree with that? Alhamdulillah. Do you agree with that?
Are you letting me talk or?
I'm asking. Yes, talk? You are talking. I'm asking to you. Number two, Allah. Number two, does it say Lillah? Lillah. Do you agree with that or I'm lying?
You are putting words.
Do you agree? No, you said that it's recorded. Everybody will laugh at you. It is recorded. You cannot say you did not say that. So when you say Lillah, Lillah, what the word Li mean? What the letter Li mean? Lillah. What Li mean? As long you claim you speak Arabic.
You're not letting me talk.
I'm asking you, what's wrong with you? What li mean? Lillah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. It's okay. So what li mean?
Isma Hamar. Listen.
He's calling me donkey now. By the way, Abdul, you don't say Hamar. You say Himar. Yeah, Himar. Don't call me Hamar.
Yes.
Himar. Okay. So let me ask you, as long as you are calling me Himar, don't you know that your prophet wife, her father is, his name is Jahsh. What Jahsh mean? It's mean donkey. So you're a prophet, he married from a woman, her last name is donkey. And not only that, your grandfather, the prophet name is Kilab, which means dogs. So you're a prophet, is a son of dogs and married to the sons of donkeys. So why you are calling me names of animals? Now, answer. Lillah. Who is Li and what is Lah?
You speak Lebanese Arabic. You know, that's not Arabic.
Abdul, answer me. Lillah. Who is Li and who is Lah? What Li mean and what Lah mean?
If my name is Theodore, does that mean that my name is Odor?
You're playing
games.
Your name is the back door. Your name is the back door. Now, answer. Don't change the topic. This is the Arabic. This is the name of your God. La, li, la. What li mean and who is la?
Okay, let's go to the Bible. In the first verse of the Genesis, it says, listen, see, you're going to hang up on me now. You're going to hang up on me.
Yes,
now.
I will hang up on you because you are a coward. You are running away. I'm asking you, why you don't want to answer? You are the one who chose the question. You are the one who chose the topic. You said to me, I want to ask you something. And finally, I said, okay, ask me something. You said that Allah is the moon god. Why you are changing topic now? Isn't it you who chose this topic?
Elohim. Tell me what does that mean.
God's il is mean God. Il. Hold on. Thank you for saying that. Let me ask you. In the Quran, it says that there's an angel. His name is Jibreel. What is the last two letters of Jibreel?
Bereshit bara Elohim.
I'm asking you, what is the last two letters of Jibreel? Jibra'il. Is the word mean God. Your false prophet, he stole the word. You do not know that Jibreel is not a name. It's a sentence. Now, if I ask you what the word Jibreel mean, what you will say?
In the Hebrew,
I'm asking you what Jibreel
means. My friend, I'm explaining. Let me explain. In the Hebrew Bible, it says Gabriel, not Jibril.
No problem. Jibril. This is in English. Okay, I'm asking you in the Arabic, you, in the Quran, what Jibril mean?
Jibril, we don't know the name, you know, what Jibril
means.
What do you know?
So are you saying to me, you Muslims, you stole the name from the Jews, but you do not know what this mean?
It's the Arabic way of the name Gabriel.
I'm asking you, so no problem, the Arabic way. So what is the Jibril mean?
We don't know.
Because you are following an ignorant, stupid prophet. Because how in the world? Okay, what Ishmael mean? Ishmael.
The one who struggled with God.
Ishmael mean the one who struggled with God. Okay, who taught you that?
That's what I've read.
I'm asking you, who taught you that? Where you read that? Where?
Wait. You talking about Ishmael or
Ishmael? Abraham? Yes, Ishmael. What Ishmael mean?
God will hear.
Okay. So where is the word God in the word Ishmael?
That's the transliteration in Hebrew.
Where is the word God in the word Ishmael? Where is the word God in the word Ishmael?
In Arabic.
I am asking you in Arabic. I don't care. Where is the word God? Where is the word God in Arabic? In the word Jibreel? No problem. Jibreel in Arabic. Where is the word God? Where we can find the word God?
I'll answer. Can I answer?
Yes, sure.
You are trying to mix Hebrew with Arabic.
I am not. You said to me Jibreel is an Arabic word. So I'm asking you. I'm asking you, Abdul. Stop being a kid. I want you to be a man for one time in your life. You said Jibreel in Arabic, so I'm saying to you, Jibreel in Arabic, where is the word God? You are the one who says that there is the word God there. Which part of the word Jibreel or Ishmael is the word God?
Are you finished?
Waiting for the answer.
It's okay, in Hebrew.
Don't tell me in Hebrew. I'm asking you, where is the word God in the Arabic Jibreel? What is the word God in the and you said to me Jibreel name include the word God?
I didn't say Jibreel, I said Gabriel, not Jibreel.
Gabriel, okay, in Arabic, Jibreel. When we say Jibreel in Arabic, the Quran, when say the word Jibreel, where is the word God? What the word Jibreel mean?
If you're not letting me talk, I cannot talk. Listen. In Hebrew, okay, it means...
I don't want in Hebrew. Stop playing a game. You are dumb like your prophet. I'm asking you, what is the name Jibreel mean in Arabic? You do not know. Okay, relax. You told me about relax. Ishmael. Relax. Okay, hold on. Ishmael, forget about Jibreel.
Relax.
No. I'm laughing. We are laughing. We are laughing at the stupidity.
You're going to have a heart attack.
No, relax. The one who have heart attack is your prophet, and he died from poison. He's already dead. I'm alive. And here we go. Answer me. All of you, 1.4 billion Muslims, none of you knows what Jibreel mean. This is because your prophet is a thief.
It means God will hear.
It means what?
God will hear.
God will hear. Guys, God will hear. Jibreel. Mm-hmm. This is the meaning of Jibreel. This is the meaning of Jibreel. This is the meaning of Jibreel. God will hear. Where do you get this from?
Look, in Hebrew, the word Ishmael, Shama means to hear.
Get
and
lost,
hear
stupid.
Means God.
Get lost, stupid idiot, donkey. I give you time more than you deserve. You just proved to us that your God Allah is the moon God. Thalah, that's your word, not my words. However, the AL, it means the in Arabic, yes. But in the ancient Aramaic, AL is equal to the word God. So each time you say the, lillah, li here is two. This li here is equal to two, the letter two. So we type here the word two. This is what the word mean. L is equal to two. Two lah. Let us make it in different colors so people can recognize better. So this letter lah, sorry, L is equal to, what is the name after that? It is lah. That is the name of your God. Lah. In here, the is equal to al, which is the word God. And this is in the ancient Hebrew and the ancient Aramaic. So even in Hebrew, the word al was God, and then it became el. So Israel, it was Israel. Ishmael, it was Ishmael. Gabriel was Gabriel. In the new Hebrew, the letter al, which is equal to God, it's not a name, it's just a word being God, is transformed into El. So we say Jesus is Emmanuel. He is God with us. And this is what happened when you have a thief who copy names, but he do not know what those names mean. The same we find with the fool Muhammad. If we go to chapter 36 in the Quran, we find that Muhammad is quoting his God as seen. Yasin. What Yasin? Who is Yasin? Look at the name of the verse. You can change to any translation. You will find that the Muslims, they have no idea what this is mean. What Yasin? Yasin. Yah is a word equal to God. It's not a name of God. It's a word equal to God. Generic word for God. But this is in the Aramaic language. Sin is the moon god. And this is why the Muslim, they could not translate it, because nobody knows what is that. You go to the interpretation, everyone he is guessing. Some they say this is Aramaic, and we do not know what Allah mean by that. But Yasin or Yasin is a word mean God, seen. God, which is the God of the moon. And those who they are, Christians, who used to worship sin when they were pagan, they use the word sin today when they translate something as equal to sin. So they say this is sin, this is pagan, this is sin, this is sin. So your God, one of his name is sin. Do you see it? Stupidity. Muhammad, he collect names, he put them in the Quran. And more proof of the collection of the of names. As an example, the Quran says that the father of Abraham is Azar. Ask any Muslim, what is the name of your father of Abraham? He will say to you, Azar. The Quran says that. The stupid author of the Quran, he thought Azar is a word mean, or it's a word which is a name. But the fact, it's not. It's a word mean a fool. So Abraham, he said to his father, Azar. Foolish. Are you going to worship idols? The stupid Muhammad, he thought that the word Azar is the name of the father of Abraham. But all of us, we can go right now. It take you 2 seconds to search. What is the name of the father of Abraham in a prophet? Google, peace upon him. And you will find that there's nobody ever mentioned such a name. But the fool Muhammad, he thought the word fool is the name of the father of Abraham. Have you ever an Aramaic person, he will call his son fool? And now the Muslim, they think that Azar is the name of the father of Abraham. But this is a word mean fool. Muhammad, he copied from the one who was translating from the gospel and from the Torah, which his name is Waraq ibn Nawfal, and the hadith referred to that clearly in Sahih hadith. So Muhammad, he heard him saying that Abraham, he said to his father, Azar. Muhammad, he thought that Azar is the name of the father, but in fact, he was saying to him, father, foolish father, you should not worship idols. Makes sense, right? That makes sense. This is foolish, father. You should not worship idols as God. And this is what happened when you follow a thief like Muhammad, who do not know what he is talking about. And this is why they do not know what Jibreel mean, what Ishmael mean, what Israel mean, what Mikael mean, what Israel, all those names Muhammad, he copied from the Jews, and he have no idea. What Abraham mean, they don't know. What Isa mean, they do not know. They don't know. What Moses mean, they don't know. For it is a theft religion. Can you show us reference? Yeah, this, you know, you can go and ask anyone who studied the ancient Aramaic, and he will show you. Azar is a fool, foolish. It's not a secret. Actually, even in your Islamic interpretation, later they notice the Christian, they start laughing at them, and they said Azar is not the name of the father of Muhammad, of Abraham. There's many Islamic scholars, they discover that this is stupid, but it's too late. Any Muslim? Did we have a good time, guys? The funny Indonesian guy who say he do not know how to say two, even this guy who don't speak two Arabic words together, he's going to challenge me in Arabic. By the way, I want to tell you something. I just ordered a lot of glue from Amazon.com. Because each time I go online, the Muslim, they destroy me. And I spent the day after that trying to glue myself together. So don't forget, thank you for your donation, because we are using it for a glue. If you wonder where the donation is going, it's for a glue, brother. Do you see what happened? I wish I can show you my face now. I have a lot of dark spots in my face right now from the beating of this guy. This guy was beating me all over. Unbelievable. Stupid cult. So, I hope that we have a good time. This video will disappear for maybe an hour, because we load it in different channel. But then always to find the videos which we just made today or the day before, remember, copy the title. After 2 hours from now or 3 hours maximum, search for the same title and filter to search for the last 24 hours, and you will find the video. All right? Very easy. شنو عسل 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 النحل جاك النحل يا تارك الصلاة شنو عسل the brother he's saying to me عسل عسل, which means like in this is an Egyptian style, they say like when somebody is doing great they say honey, you know. So I'm saying to him, don't say honey, there's a lot of bees around. If I show you from my windows what I have, you will be scared. Even though it's very cold, I don't know how the bees can live until now. It's a freezing outside, unbelievable. All right. No, we are going to use the quality of life. You know, I will make a video there soon. But you have to give me an idea, topic to talk about it. All right. And we are posting here videos have nothing to do with Islam too, because we don't want to keep our channel empty. You know, because we don't keep here anything. As you know, YouTube did target us. What we can do. All right, my friend. Remember carefully. We are, you see, the reason we are sure of a victory, not because you have a Christian prince. Christian prince is no one. Victory always comes from the Lord. The one who stands with the truth, he will never be defeated. The Lord, he said, they can kill your body. What is the benefit of a man? He can win the whole world, but he lost his soul. So the winning we do, we win souls. It's not about a body. It's not about a land. It's not about money. It's not about a government. We don't care for those things, because everything will be demolished. And everything will go. The Lord, he says, everything will perish except my words. Will not. So the word of the Lord is going to defeat every cult exists in this earth. Not only the cult of Muhammad the thief. And a Christian prince is nothing but just a person transferring knowledge which you don't have, because let us say God he helped me to speak Arabic. God he gave me the gift to know, to recognize, to be able to connect the dots together. And God he gave me a gift which is called the brain. Thank you, Lord, for what I have. So everything I have is a gift from my Lord, nothing of my own. And by him we are victorious. And this is why when we go live on air, we say, we challenge anyone to call us. We don't know who's going to call. And we don't care who will call. Because it doesn't matter who call, he is going to be in trouble. And he will face an extreme humiliation of ignorance and stupidity. Not only because he is a fool, but because he is following a fool. And this is what happened to you when you are a fool following a fool. If the best example of you is a fool, so what you expect from those who follow a fool? When the Quran says the sun set in a murky water, and then we show them Muhammad saying that, explaining that, not only the Quran saying that, how you follow a fool, how you can do so. It is stupid. This is logic. We talk about Allah, he's talking about Theodore. What Theodore have to do with my... We are talking about ancient language. What Theodore have to do with our topic? This is stupid. So we are showing what those letters who they are in the beginning, they are not part of the name. This is why in the first verses in the Quran, one it says Allah, the second verse says Lillah, because simply it's not a name, the first two letters. It's not part of the name. That's why you can take them off. When I say the Christ, that is not part of the name, but I cannot take any letters out of the Christ as a Christ. But that I can say. I can say Christ said to me. But I can say the Christ. But Christ do not need that because he is the only one. There's no other Christ. And this is why, even in Arabic, it says Al-Masih. Al-Masih. Al is added before names which is not to be in competition with any. وَقَوْلَهُمْ إِنَّا قَتَلْنَا الْمَسِيحِ. Why he is Al-Masih? Because there's only one Messiah and divine to be the only one. There's many Muhammad, there's many Isa, but there's only one Christ. And this is why Muslims are not allowed to give a name to any child of their own as Al-Masih. If somebody claim to be or call himself Al-Masih, the Muslims will kill him immediately. But you can call yourself Muhammad. Because the Messiah is the Lord and nobody earned his name. Even in your stupid cult. The name of the Masih, my friend, in Arabic, in English, in Hebrew, it doesn't matter. The second you say it, a human being, his body is in trouble. He is like an electric shot. And this is how the Muslims even feel when they say the word Al-Masih. It's a very powerful name. It doesn't matter who is the one reading the name. The second you say the Masih, you feel something different. And maybe many people do not know. There's a lot of churches in the Middle East sponsored by the donation of Muslims for the sake of Al-Masih, because they knew Muhammad have no healing. Anyone have a problem from the Muslims believe, he go to the Masih asking for help. He don't go to Muhammad. Muhammad, he died because of a poison, and Allah, neither him could not save him. Very slow death. That is Muhammad. And this story here raised many questions. If Muhammad is the most beloved prophet for Allah, as Muslims they claim, so why Allah, he saved Isa, but he did not save Muhammad? The truth is ugly, my friend. And the Muslims cannot handle the truth. Right? That is the truth. Anyway, I want to say thank you all for being here. Remember, this video will disappear from my channel for 2-3 hours. Again, after 3 hours, search for how to approach a Muslim and save him from Islam. Search it a few hours from now, and you will have the video posted again in different channels. Until we go again live on air, if the Lord, you want us to do so, I say may the Lord bless you all. And if you like to learn more about Islam, you can read my books. And I have now more translation posted. We have Six and Allah in Spanish. And, you know, we have Six and Allah in Dutch. We have Six and Allah in German. All of those, they are up and in Amazon in the last 7 days only. So I'm glad for those who help us for the translation, so many people from many languages can read and they can learn. Thank you. May the Lord bless you all. And until I see you again, Christ is Lord. Islam is false. And we prove it every day. And as Muhammad, he said, as a Jew, he said to Muhammad, this is how we do it. Thank you.